Swiss.
Thank you.
Greetings, you people, hello, my king. How's it going? How has it been? This Barstona do indeed welcome you to Sunday morning heroes, everybody. We're about to get right back into the thick of it. Our protagonists are being hounded by zombies and ogres. However, strangely enough, it's their allies. We have with us once again this morning, Quilly Teen.
Hey, folks.
We also have a kiss for luck.
Hey, yeah.
And, of course, Demonac.
Greetings.
All right, so, everybody, yeah, we're about to get into it. I need to get some face time in 3 and 2 and 1 and faces all around. Okay, so, you guys ready for this? I think you're ready to get into another battle. You kicked open the door and you have, certain unsavory individuals to, dispatch, if you will.
Yeah, the only problem is right before we went live, somehow Demonac took a critical hit to his internet, so he sounds like he's coming through a 2400 baud modem for some reason.
Yeah,
and he was fine a second ago, and now not so much.
Yeah, I'm noticing that right now. He looks, you're actually a freeze frame of pixels right now too.
We're basically like how we used to be on Roll 20.
Yeah,
everything is fine except,
everything.
Oh wait.
Yeah, I barely heard that, but yeah, okay. Well, maybe. Well, what can you do? I mean, we're gonna try to master it. We got Castmaster coming in with a 20 septum donation. Thank you very much.
Mine's
starting it off proper.
In Task Manager, you can see if there's any apps using network. So maybe there's something downloading in the background, Steam, something like that. If you just control, shift, escape to bring up Taskmaster, you can see if there's anything stealing your bandwidth.
No. Hakun says he looks like he's preparing for cryo sleep. Sorry. I just realized something too. Like, everything seems to be broken on my thing. Like, everything stopped. I'm looking off here and. What the hell?
I just lost the chat. But I like the chat.
What's happening? Technical difficulties, apparently.
Yeah, Twitch just dumped the chat for me, and it's like, no, I like these people.
Yeah, everything just sort of stopped. In terms of, well, there we go. Now everything's back. That's weird.
Okay.
That was really strange. Everybody's able to move again.
Okay.
Seems like, good.
Have that again.
The hell was that then?
Yeah, everything. Yeah, all the. I did notice that the videos froze in the video for a bit.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Except, I mean, Demonac, even within Skype, even with him locally, like, everything is poop.
Everything is poopy.
I can't see him locally. If I check the now that Twitch is working, I can see like a frozen face in there. I can't see him in Skype at all. Mm. Like, I have no Demonac at all. I haven't for a while.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I see the face, and the face is not moving.
As long as I can hear him, that's the part that counts anyway.
Yeah, Demon
Can
Dax.
We even hear him?
I don't know. Can we hear you?
Nope.
That would be a no. Can we hear you? Bloop. I'm out of here, man. Mm-hmm. Hey, he's back! That looks good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Actually, you know what? Well, we'll take it while we have it. Okay, so... Oh, and, what's that? Daniel Dansku. Thank you very much for your generosity. We have $1.31 septums coming in. It's amazing. Wait, did I say dollar and septums together? I'm mixing currency here.
$1.31 septums.
Three guineas, 2 shillings.
I like it.
7 septums.
Yes.
There you go. Perfect.
You need to switch over to one of those economies where your currency is just like a rock. It doesn't move. You just like claim, like, I will give you this large rock.
That could work.
You know that you own it, so if you need something in the future, you can say, well, okay, I will give you this large rock that I own. It's over there.
Yeah. It's like, well, it's like giving space and territory, though. You could say that. It's like you're a rock. Now you can go sit on that rock. So you're basically giving people land at that point.
Yeah, is it? It was basically a virtual currency already, because they were bringing over one of those rocks and it fell in the ocean, and they all agreed that, like, well, we know where it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have a flag? No, but I have a rock.
Yeah.
Mm. Mm. Hey. So, right, so if you guys want to get into the thick of combat, it's there before you. I don't know how you want to proceed. You do have two large individuals who happen to not enjoy taking damage, but they do indeed have a... What's that? Initiative. Oh, well, there's the initiative.
Yeah, I was going to say, how we're going to proceed first is probably rolling initiative.
I seem to remember we were supposed to be rolling initiative when we left, so...
Yeah. Okay. So let's go ahead and do that.
Where's the button?
That's turn. I know.
Go.
Where's my dice?
Oh, it's going to be that kind of a week. You can always tell by my first roll. I'm either 25 and above, or it's sweep all.
It's sweep all?
Yeah, well, you know, it's going to be nice.
Wow.
It's just a blank. It's just a blank there.
You just fill in the blank with whatever you want. Sweep, crocodile all. Yeah, that's the thing. That's what you're saying. Lord.
Well, I'm ahead of the two other guys. It's that
hard. Well, it's kind of hard not to be ahead of the other two.
I know, exactly. I can beat somebody with a two. Oh,
woo!
So good. I'm so excited. So what did we have going on here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. Can't we just send
them? It's like that other group that we fought, except this time we aren't launching a wave of zombies first.
Yeah, no, the wave of zombies are in behind.
That's a shame.
Now, they'll probably end up moving forward, or at least trying to fit through, like, filing through, like, a B-rated zombie movie where they kind of, like, get in and stuck on each other trying to get through the door. You know? So, there's probably going to be that sort of thing. Everybody sucks on my team. Team?
That's
team
good.
DM right now sucks.
Hey,
right,
I'm one ahead of the suck team. Woohoo!
Yeah. Hey, as long as you still go 12, first, you know?
And the fastest
has party-based 11. Initiative.
What was that, sorry?
Their damage can come in all at once, pretty much.
I'm going to roll for the zombies and see what they do. The zombies have what? Oh, sorry. That's not what I want to look at. Can I close that, please, Council? Thank you. I want to take a look at your dex. Okay, so you have a -2. Right, yeah, -2 to your modifier. So let's see. All the zombies are going to go on the same... Really? Well, I'm rolling just bad altogether. Zombies are going on a 5. So I'm just going to go ahead and put one in. Instead of like a whole crap ton of them. Why can't I actually see the screen here? Alright. Add turn. Thank you. No, what the... Okay. There it is. So these guys are going to go on a 5. Yep. Like so. So if one zombie moves, they all move. And, I need to roll for Gira as well. Just remember that. That's going to be you, sir. That turn.
Come on. Be a big one.
Nope, unfortunately. He's on an 8. What the hell, man? Everybody I'm rolling for. Maybe I'll get crits now. I'm gonna get nothing but crits.
Badly.
Yes, okay. All right, put you in like that. And you are going at a... Alright. That's it. Everybody I rolled for are all crap. Everybody's crap. Right? However, you kick open the door, and you see before you the unsavory individuals, which might not be unsavory. You know what? They could have been playing a game prior to you showing up and ready to deal death. And maybe they would have invited you in on it.
They could be
maybe
very,
they're very
savory.
Maybe they've been simmered with a bay leaf.
They have a smoky, like, aftertaste.
Yeah.
Well, the three guys over there were obviously in bed. They just jumped up out of bed. That's what it was. And the other two were sitting there having tea. And they, you know, they one spilled his tea and went to wipe it and then looked up and went, oh, God. Yeah, I understand how this can happen. That's okay. We got this. We got this.
Yeah, you have this. I mean, come on. You have the overwhelming numbers, that's for sure. Right. All right. So, anyway, how do you want to proceed? Apparently, Eric is top of the order. So,
they're going first.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
At least we have, like, one, you know, meaty, beefy person rolling high. The fact that the ogres rolled so bad was disheartening.
I'm going to move in next to this guy. And by fifth ed rules, I can keep moving next to him. As long as I don't move away from him, he doesn't get an attack of opportunity.
So that's right. 5, that's true.
Then 15. Cool. And here, I'm going to try and smash him with the bust.
Okay. Oh, the bus.
I
heard bus. I was, so when did you pick up a bus?
The bus, imbued with the power of the Iron Fang artifact, smash this guy for 15 damage.
Right.
In Soviet D&D, you pick up bus.
Yeah.
Right, then, so 15 damage.
I do have a second attack now because of our level. Didn't come up last fight basically at all, which is hilarious because it was all like spellcasting. But you can split up your attacks in fifth ed along with your move. Before I do that, I'm going to try and grapple this guy as a bonus action because I hit him with an improvised weapon.
Ah, okay.
15 off the grapple check.
Right. he has a really good chance to. He rolled a 1. What the shit?
Okay. So,
all right, so he's grappled.
So I hit him with the bust, and I get my like my arm around him, basically. And I'm not sure how this works with the shield, except that I might have to be hitting the shield or something. But I get my arm around him, and then I'm going to start dragging him. Now, I've already moved 15. You can only move half speed while dragging. So I guess I probably can only move 1 square with him. So I pull him along behind me.
Just all right.
This way. I want to get over and try and block that other door if possible. I'm not going to get there this turn, though. So I'll just use my second attack to try and, like, eat him some more.
Wait, so you hit him with a big stony piece of, well, stone, grab him and yank him over, and you're going to hit him again. This is just brutal.
Yeah.
Well, actually, you're going to miss this time.
I'm going to miss this time. Yeah. It's harder, apparently, when I'm grappling him, even though it doesn't really affect anything.
No, he's struggling.
The fact of the grapple is that he can't move away unless he wants to, you know, make a grapple check, and I think that costs him his action, so, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I couldn't figure out why you weren't going adjacent to the caster and then, like, blocking the door. I'm like, oh, yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. Things could happen from the door side.
Because I can't go that far, I should have just, like, probably gone next to the caster instead, but eh.
All right.
Okay. That was my turn. It was plenty of turn.
It's now Death Dealer's turn.
Well, here's the problem, though, right? Like, I would love to go in and just, like, explode the caster or something. But then I feel like what would happen next is I would get exploded from these various guards.
Could happen.
That makes me feel very not good. But if I just stay outside, I'm not going to deal a whole lot of damage, and I'm worried that, well, then Eric would get obliterated too quick.
Well, he's the tank, you know, that's what tanks do.
It's too bad we hadn't opened this whole thing up a little bit more. Look around the corner here. There's 2 little arrow slits. You could just do your little stealth around the corner thing.
Oh, my.
And right through that arrow and take that guy out right through the eyeball. It'd be awesome.
Yeah. Or as soon as I look through there, he's got a crossbow that shoots me in my other eye.
Yeah, he's going to be looking at the door. He's going to be looking at the door. All this stuff just exploded
in. You can get around that, do is you make sure that you peek through the arrow slit using your missing eye. Because then if they shoot it, nothing happens.
I don't know if that's how that works, to be honest. You have a missing eye, so it's a shield,
very
too.
Logical. It's very logical.
All right, I'm going to come in here.
You won't lose your sight in that eye, right? That's something.
I'm going to get next to the caster, although I guess we could focus fire to kill one dude.
Yes.
If I hit him a second time, that would be effective, but I don't know.
All right, we're going to go. I'll go to this guy.
All right.
And I will stabify him once. To start off with, and then we're going to figure out what happens after that.
Okay.
So, I will try to stab him with my Star Motif Dagger. Right. A 13's probably not going to cut it.
No. Well, pun not intended or pun intended. 13's not going to cut it.
Your stabbing action to cutting action.
I see.
Yeah, let me luck that. It's early in the fight. We really need to get, like, maybe 1 source of damage offline, so... Let's try this again.
Offline.
Oh.
Okay. So,
Fortian day.
Specify what kind of luck.
Good. Yeah, that's true. Apparently, I got the crap luck.
Right. Well, this is not going to do it.
so you moved in. I could use my bonus action to get a second attack, or I could use my bonus action to GTFO and not die.
Right.
I kind of feel like I'm going to use the latter. Since I don't think a second attack is going to kill him. I think I needed to hit twice to kill him.
Yeah.
They are pretty beefy.
If I had hit
beefy.
Both times, it'd be different.
Yeah. So I will use my bonus action to use my celerity ability to, like, warp speed out of here without drawing attack of opportunity.
Okay. Good. How long does that last again?
Just the 1 round. It costs me 2 power points. It gives me plus 30 move and draw no attacks of opportunity this turn.
Okay, very good. Also, I want to say, Sildarl, thank you very much for your generosity.
Thank you.
Currently, it's now Lisanne's turn.
Yes, so I can I can move up here and shoot through the door.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if you can shoot through a door, but you might want to open, you know, like the door.
The door's open, right?
Yeah, the door's okay. Open. So shoot through the door.
So I'm just thinking, like, that's the caster right here, right? This, the guy with the color something. So if I just move into this area, I can just shoot through the door right there.
Yes.
These guys are all bigger than me. I do this really slick thing I learned in the woods where you just kind of crouch down under the legs.
Oh, don't roll a one. You don't tell me that. Hush. And then roll a one.
Hush.
You're going to have somebody go either completely enraged immediately.
Now we know it's your fault if I do. I'm just saying.
Oh, God. You're rolling. Oh, no. All right. I don't normally do this. Because I called it out.
Couldn't we do play Europa or something just this one?
He did say something first about it. Just kind of, he's kind of got to do something now.
It's not going to affect too many things. Okay, you do 6 damage. You do 6 piercing damage to the gonads of Jerk.
No!
Right, because you're shooting between his legs. Okay.
I got his ankle. Come on, be nice.
It tags him in a place that sends him immediately into a rage.
No, we don't do that.
He's immediately raging right now. This guy.
We don't do that anymore, do we?
And your second attack does what now? Oh, it does hit though.
18.
I'm pretty sure an arrow to the genitals does more than 6 damage. Well, my hit points are kind of abstract.
Yeah.
At some point, that's like not just like damage rolls.
Here's anymore. What we're gonna say though. It doesn't actually, because he has really. I'm not gonna get into the to the anatomy of this guy, but he's really stony balls, right? So the thing is it actually tags him and it like sends him into a rage, but it doesn't really do any damage. I'm not taking any damage off of him, but he's in a rage. No, he's just automatically into a rage.
Okay, so do these crits actually? I thought we didn't do that anymore. Am I wrong?
No, we don't normally, but I called it first. I called it first. That was
fact,
I called it. So instead of roll a one, something was gonna happen. So, and you rolled a one. It's just fantastic.
Rule of funny.
Yeah, rule of funny. All right, so 13 points of damage. Yeah. You're attacking the which one? Sorry.
I'm so ashamed. He's not gonna like me anymore.
Or maybe, you know what, instead of an arrow, you didn't actually hit him with the arrow. You kind of slid in all cool.
Yeah,
and you accidentally
hitting with the arrow.
With your
so you're okay. Boop. That's better than what I was thinking. I just slid it. I pictured you had me hitting my freaking forehead someplace unpleasant. So it's like, no.
That's the sound that it
made. You said you were like bent down and trying to shoot through his legs. You said you were going like dropping down like sort of between his legs. So yeah, you just hit him with like the edge, like the top end of the bow, like you miscalculated.
Oh yeah.
And it like goes into a rage.
While you're trying to aim.
I like that one. I like that one. I just slid in and clipped him with the top of the bow. It's like, oh, yeah. Sorry. That's great.
It's like how in rodeos, how they get like the bucking broncos to buck.
Yeah.
Is they get that strap.
Yes.
It's the same thing. You just made him really angry now. Yeah.
He's really mad.
I just encouraged him to participate fully. Okay, this is actually working out fine. This is good.
Oh, and you have disadvantage because now you haven't
come on.
Sorry. All right, that was too far. All right. Anyway, so which one were you hitting? Were you hitting the armored dude or the mage?
The caster.
The caster. Okay, so the caster is going to take 13 points of damage.
I can see him at an angle. I didn't think I could, like, shoot around the corner for the other guys.
No, you had to go farther. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so Tal goes, Lasan goes. It is now this guy's turn. Oh, he doesn't even see the ogre. He has no idea an ogre exists. But he's going to run up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, he saw Tal go outside. He should just like run outside and then pull like a Han Solo there.
So he comes up to the door and he sees like the red already in this thing's eyes. Holy shit. So he's going to go ahead and attack him. And he's going to use his sword.
I don't think I get a third attack because the other guy's too far away. They've got to be kind of closer than that.
Right.
So.
Yeah,
he's
going to that
hit
up for
minimum damage. But he's going to hit. Oh, and he crits. Okay.
Ow.
So he's going to hit the big ogre guy twice in a row. So it's going to be I'm gonna have to roll this.
Does Lissan not get a third attack? Because are they not adjacent?
She was just saying that they're too far apart now.
I would like to ask something, because I think about this every single week, and then we always forget at the end of it. Now, normally I have to have two people, like the two at the table, they're too far apart to get the second attack. But when you're looking at the line of sight where I am, like this guy and this one back here, they are more than 5 feet apart. But in a melee, it wouldn't work. But in terms of an arrow here and then right next to it further, wouldn't that work? I don't know.
That's not how this thing is designed.
I don't know.
No.
Yeah, if you were using like an AoE, you could put it in the middle, but that's not. Yeah. Your ability works differently. They have to be right next to each other, I think.
Yeah.
And if you have it as an AoE,
for melee, that makes perfect sense. Hit, give a swipe kind of thing. With arrows, it always kind of messes with my head. Like, why couldn't I get the guy standing there? I don't, you know, but I've always wanted to ask. Now I know. Let's go.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so Rose says, I can't believe I'm saying this, but is Briarstone a bit quiet? So I just turned myself up, so hopefully it's not too loud. So the guy hits, actually. He comes into the doorway, and he freaks out as he sees the very, very red eyes of this giant mass of meat. And he does take a swing twice with his sword, and he does 19 points of damage, because he also critted. Jirth is not feeling well. I mean, despite having been... you know, tipped off into being angry, which is good that this guy hit him, though, because he's angry, and he probably would go after the first person who tipped him off there, but, you know, however, he's got a new target now. So Gudra's turn. He sees his sort of compatriot, we're not going to call him his father, taking some attacks. These guys are rather large, but he doesn't have to move, actually. Gudra's going to stand exactly where he is, over the top of, Tau. In fact, not Tau, Lissan. Lissan, I'm going to move you just over here.
Oh, well, whatever. Yeah, okay. You just pushed me out of the way. I understand. Okay, that's fine.
And he's going to take a swing at this guy, and he's going to probably do a massive amount of damage. Okay, or he's going to miss entirely. Let's get another swing then. Two very, very heavy swings, and he misses. I can't roll for nothing.
Apparently, none of us are rolling particularly well today.
Today,
honestly.
I'm thinking, you know, at the rate it's going, we'll just have to change games or something.
This is going to be like 3 hours of this fight as we just keep winning.
Damn it!
As we kill them all with boredom, die from boredom.
Okay, yeah. Okay, he hits. So the one next to the one that's being dragged around by Demonag, by Eric, does make his first attack, and he. He will miss the second attack. His first attack is going to do only 5 points of damage, though. Because he rolled minimum.
So I take -3, I take 2 damage to my temporary hit points. Yay!
Right. I'll let you handle your health. And... Right, that's his turn. I mean, he's going to try to break grapple as well. And move. Roll against the grapple check, I guess. It's if you don't roll a 1, you've got him.
Okay.
Don't roll a 1.
Yeah, easy. I rolled a 3, so he's still being dragged around.
Excellent.
All right, so it is now the mage's turn. The mage is, you know, he could see through the doorway at this particular vantage. What he's going to do is he's going to cast a spell, and the ceiling above you turns to mud and starts to fall.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna get all dirty.
Yep. I don't think it does immediate damage. Let me make sure. If it does immediate damage, I think it does damage to anybody who ends their turn in the area.
But then he's gonna cast it again, and then we'll just get like coated in hard rock.
Yep. Yeah. Hard rock. Yeah.
Oh.
All right. Where is it called? It's I forget what it's called.
Transmute Rock.
Transmute Rock, thank you. Let me look it up.
Transmute Rock to elevator music.
There we go. Yeah.
No.
You're like, is this Rolling Stones on a piccolo?
Oh my god. Right. Any creature under the mud when it falls must make a dexterity saving throw. Okay, so no, it goes immediately. Right, so...
So That's unpleasant.
So we have, I guess, Jirth, Lissan, and Gira. And how big is the area? Making sure I get this right.
Yeah, because it's
40.
It's...
Oh, wow. That's oh, a it's large huge. Rate. Yeah, it's huge. All right. So, in fact, it's going to be 10, 20, 30, 40. It's even going to hit the zombies, which is hilarious.
Isn't it going to hit him, too?
No. He's cast it out in around the zombies. He's like right in here. So he's casting it. And it's just turning the entire ceiling in that entire area into mud.
So I assume it reaches me as well?
Oh, yeah. So everybody.
Deck save?
Deck save, yep. The zombies are. What the hell? The zombies are going to make it.
Where's mine? I rolled it.
The zombies are going to make their save. No, you did not quite make it. No.
Come on. Any
what do I do? Slip and fall? Or are we taking actual damage?
You're actually taking damage. You take 4d8. I'll roll it in a moment.
Jeepers!
21.
Okay, yeah, you make your dex save. And it's saved for half, I do believe. Yeah, half as much. So I'm going to roll the damage here in just a second. Okay, so Gira needs to roll. He fails. Jirth fails. All right, so here's the damage. We've got... ...24 points of damage. That hurts.
I get 24 or I get half of that?
You get half of that. Okay. So it's 12 for you. So actually, you know what? A large chunk of this mud, this heavy, heavy mud, just comes crashing down at a speed that just knocks Jirth right out. Jirth is out, cold, on the ground, done.
That's awful.
48.
Yep.
Sorry, yeah, how much damage are we taking?
Oh.
24.
Damn.
And these guys are also taking, like, ow. Gira is also going down. Or not going down, sorry. Gira's still up, but he's really badly hurt.
I am bloodied and muddied.
Okay.
Damn.
Every single zombie saved. Because I just rolled once for them. So minus 12.
Holy cow.
Which is funny, because if they didn't save, they would probably have to roll their checks, because their health is just under that.
It's not nice at all.
We were taking our hit points for granted.
Oh, here it goes.
Nice.
Wow.
You know, if I were smart, I wouldn't be doing the whole this adventuring. I'd stay home and just be sedentary.
Yep. Oh.
This is brutal. All right, well, his ability to attack was really good.
Ignatius on the radio? Or Igneous?
Igneous, uh-huh.
Damn it.
All right, he's going to move to the other side of the doorway here, out of line of sight. He's going to hang out right here. Nice and safe. Okay. It is the swarm of zombies' turn. Here they come, everybody. They're going to come
in there and be meat.
Gum up the doorway. Blah, 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 blah. Except they can't really get through. Well, you know what?
Of course they can.
Yeah. They're just going to run straight in. In fact, what's going to happen is they're all going to move in. They're going to attack and then continue their move just inside the doorway. They're all going to attack this guy right here.
Okay.
This is what happens with a swarm of zombies.
Five of them just plow right over the guy.
Run over him like a tree.
And they're just basically 5 foot stepping like through him into the other side. So that doesn't actually promote an attack of opportunity, I don't think. He's just moving around him. Yeah. Swimming around.
If they leave his square, that's when he would get an attack.
Yeah, I basically put them where they are. They're just like 5 feet beyond him or beside him. I just put them where they are because it's easier for me to see. First one is going to miss. Second one's going to miss. Third one is... What is your bonuses again? Plus what? What is your plus? I guess, it'd be plus. Gonna miss, okay. And... That one's gonna miss. How many have I rolled? Is that 4 or 5? Anybody count?
I don't know.
Nope.
I'm gonna roll again.
I heard 3 for sure.
It doesn't matter if I did indeed roll again. They all missed. Every single one of them missed. They're more concerned about getting around him and into the room to swarm and look cool than hitting the actual person.
They all missed him.
Every single one of them. All right, so now it's Jirth's turn, except Jirth doesn't get to go. In fact, Jirth, because he's going to make a saving throw. He fails it. One strike against Jirth.
Yeah, death saves.
We have this guy is going to move now. He is completely and utterly surrounded, or will be surrounded by zombies. He's going to move in and he's going to try to take one out. At the very least. He's going to miss. Actually, no. They have really shitty AC, don't they? They do.
Zombies? Okay.
Yeah, no, he hits. Regardless of his really bad roll, and by really bad, I mean really bad. He hits. He barely hits. All right, so he's going to do 11 points of damage, which is going to be done to this zombie here, which means that the zombie will probably die, except for his roll is at least a 6 easily done. He does not die. He stays at hit point 1. He remains alive.
Zombies for the win, although they haven't been horribly used. Well, I guess in the last fight.
They've been tanking a lot of damage.
They got away a lot in the last fight.
So this guy's going to go. He's going to move up.
Better they got than us.
He's gonna hit the same zombie, and if they don't, does he hit? Oh yeah, he hits just barely again, and he's gonna do 6 points of damage. 6 points of damage. So I have to roll higher than
11.
Zombie is still there. He's just like duh, duh, and still standing. Very good, Eric. Your turn.
Okay. Well, things have changed slightly. I'm gonna start out. Right, like I've got my arm around this guy with the bust. I'm basically gonna keep like headbutting him with the bust.
Uh-huh.
I'm not sure how that works. I'm just my understanding is that the improvised weapon feat that's letting me like grapple people with the items is actually letting me grapple them with the items and not causing weird hand issues.
Right.
So anyway, try smash number 1. AC 13, that's not very good. And second attack. It's even worse.
And me hitting our own guy in the privates.
But I will move over to the door and drag the guy along with me.
So okay.
He's still grappled, so at least I can prevent anyone else from getting out of the room that way. That's
okay. So you are definitely a not only a tank but a doorstop. Understood.
Yep, right now.
A doorstop.
All right,
and
so you
turn out the door opens outwards.
Yeah, it's just like, whoop, wait a second. Very good. So those two attacks miss, though, so that's fine.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, really good damage, mind you, but yeah, both miss. So Tao, it is now your turn.
Yeah. Well, I'm actually a little concerned after all that damage that I took.
Oh, by the way, the ceiling
again,
is still
mud. He doesn't have line of sight right now.
Just so you know.
What's that?
The ceiling is still mud. It is still coming down.
Wait, really?
Yes.
If I stay here, I'm going to take more damage.
Yep.
So Gear is going to take more damage from being there. Like, that's not good.
Oh, God.
Yeah, if he takes damage, I think it automatically causes one death, like, tick.
You could try to, like, drag him out of it.
Yeah, that doesn't seem really feasible. He's large.
The
maybe
only
his son
who can really
do
that is pretty much Eric. Although, I mean, Gira could do it. Gira might.
Lasan is super buff.
Oh, this is true, actually.
She's super buff. She's got like a 16 strength or something crazy like that.
She's got like muscles on top of muscles.
I assume if I go here, I'm not going to be underneath the mudfall.
Yeah, no, moving inside the door at all, the way it's angled, the way the guy had put it up, in fact, the way instead of actually even coming into the doorway, it comes from the ceiling and down the wall. The wall seems a little bit slick, and it's sliding down mud, but it's not inside this room. So moving inside this room is actually, strangely enough, safe, despite all.
So the mud. If we stay out in the hallway, is the mud a problem like every turn for a while, or is it done?
I will let you know. Let's see. Make sure I get everything right.
I mean, if that's doing like 5d8 every turn, like I got a scroll of that shit. I'm gonna start spamming that stuff. Actually, no, Eric's got it, I think. One of us has got a scroll of that.
You got a scroll of what, sorry?
One of us has a scroll of Transmute Rock.
That sounds familiar. I don't have it written.
We did! What do you guys do?
Mm-hmm.
Did we give it to Eric because he has these weird
spell casting
things we don't understand?
Hold on. It just says instantaneous. It doesn't say...
Well, I was going to say, I don't think... I was going to look it up, too. I don't expect it lasts.
No, I'm guessing it doesn't. Okay, so basically, it changes enough mud to fall, but then that's it.
Yeah.
That's just the casting. Okay, understood.
Yeah. Instantaneous also means you can't. The dispelling wouldn't turn it back into stone.
Right. Okay. No. So you could stay outside. Sorry.
I'll actually stand here. And actually, I realized I wouldn't be able to squeeze through the door anyway because he's blocking the doorway.
Mm.
So I will stand here, but then I will stabify him.
Stabify him muchly, please.
Stabify him muchly.
I'm gonna divert all power to weapons.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
And we got what then?
That one worked.
That's definitely gonna hit, and you're hitting the dude in the doorway, right?
Yeah. Was he bloodied? Had he taken any damage or anything like that?
No, this guy is fresh.
Okay.
Every zombie missed.
All fresh.
Well, let's see if we can make him slightly less fresh by using a 5 power point lethal strike.
Ow.
24.
So 32 damage total.
Sweetness.
Right. Well, if I recall, these guys have like 50 or something hit points.
I think they have 50-ish hit points.
Yeah.
So if he takes 32 damage, your dagger finds its way underneath one of its plates and into his shoulder, and then the energy from that strike blows off chunks of his armor off the side there, and he's like really badly hurt.
Ooh, I'm dropping his AC.
Flavor. Savor the flavor. Lasan.
Nope.
Oh, actually, wait.
Bonus action.
Oh, shit.
I'm going to attack my other weapon.
Can you miss? All right.
I did miss, and I'm not going to use a luck on it.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Glad.
Cut.
Damn it. All right.
Yeah.
Lasan, your turn.
He's still alive, this thing in front of us?
Yep. You could, you can make him feel better. You know, you punched him in the nuts and
now you're
trying to peel him.
I click, nothing happens.
What?
I click twice, nothing happens.
Oh, maybe just give it a second. It might,
we'll wait for a minute.
Because the other time when you, the save, it eventually went
there
twice.
It is.
There's one. I hit him once, right? Sure. I don't know where the second one is.
Which one are you aiming for? Sorry.
The guy in the doorway there.
Right in front of you? Yeah, no, that's going to miss, actually.
That's a miss.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the second is never going to happen.
They have really good armor. There's the other one. And that one will hit.
Good.
13 points of damage. All right.
Is he done?
No.
He's not as fresh as he used to.
The arrow sticks in his shoulder where the armor blew off there. But he is really badly wounded, but he is still standing.
Maybe the zombies will get him.
Boiled.
Could happen. So that's your two rolls. So it is now whose turn?
Drop somebody.
Oh, it's his turn. All right. So what is he gonna do? Right, he's got.
He's got a lot of arm strain there. I hear that attracts zombies, right? They're like strain.
Right. He's gonna take a swing. Oh, and he's gonna hit. I'm pretty sure. What's your AC, Tao? I mean, Tao. Okay. Yeah. No, he's definitely gonna hit. And he is going to do.
Yeah, I have a 21. Has it been adjusted to properly show 21? 12 points
of damage on his first hit. Huh? What? Sorry.
Oh, yeah, okay, you've got the right AC. Okay.
Yeah.
12 points of damage?
Yep. And the second one he's going to miss, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, thank God.
He easily misses on the second swing. However, he did, he's fighting hard despite being really badly injured. And in fact, does he want to draw?
I'm down to 9 hit points.
He's surrounded by zombies. There's nothing. This is a very terrifying situation for him. There's nowhere he can go that's going to be helpful. So he's going to, just stand his ground, I guess. If he tries to leave, he's more than likely going to die. If he tries to stay, he's more than likely going to die. The best thing he can do is, die. All right, Gira. Oh, Jesus, Gira's going to get to go. Can Gira finish him off, I wonder? Actually, what was your to hit? I'm pretty sure it... No, he misses. First swing by Gira misses. Second swing by Gira, that also is going to... No, that's going to hit. It's just got minimum damage. All right. Yeah, minimum damage. Is going to do... How much damage? Making sure I get this right. Oh, wait. I'm rolling die. So he hits. So it makes a lot more difference if I roll the right die now. So he's gonna do. ...18 points of damage. Alright, this guy gets obliterated. He gets knocked so hard, he just gets swung. The axe, or the pick or whatever that Gira is using there, comes swinging around, catches the guy right in the chest, BOOM! And he's trying to rip it back out of him, but it just drags him along with it and smashes him against the wall on the other side here. This guy is down. There's nothing he can do about it, he is gone.
We got one!
Right? Moves him out of the doorway. He's like, ah! Okay. Now, it is this guy who is currently being dragged around by... You know what? First things first. We're going to roll strength check. Or athletics. Yeah. Sorry.
I'm pretty sure that actually takes an action for him to try and break out, eh?
Yeah, like, that's just it. He wants out of it.
Okay.
He wants out of it. He does not want to be over here. Useless.
Well, I mean, he can attack while being grappled. He's just not allowed to move away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He just wants out of it. And he is going to move away. He's going to go over here, and he's going to help his buddy try to kill at least one zombie. The one zombie that they're all, like, banging on. And if it doesn't work this time, I'm going to say their morale is going to get tanked.
It takes an action for him to try and break out of the grapple, so he's not attacking this turn.
He can't even attack once, even if he got multiple attacks?
That's right. Yeah, it's not like an attack that takes an attack. It takes an action. The reason that... do it as a bonus action is because I have a feat, and right. If I hit someone first, I can spend a bonus action and try and grapple them.
Well, you know what? It's already done. So I'm gonna say he moves over there and he gets there just in time to you know do nothing. All right, so whatever.
Yeah,
it's his turn. I'm not gonna back up on that one. So we have a caster who is surrounded by zombies who is not exactly happy. What are you going to do? I'll tell you what's going to happen. Right now, in the middle of the floor, erupts a giant hand. Up through the ground comes a giant hand. And that giant hand is going to swing around, and he's going...
One zombie at a time?
Well, yeah, basically that. He's
okay, that's fine. Just clarify.
It's very, very impressive, right? Okay, so that hand is going to grapple and possibly damage the zombie. I have to roll what again? That's, let me just make sure. As cool as it would be just for me to make it up as I go along.
That never happens. Oh, right. Sorry.
Where is it there? There it is. That's the one. So, so... Strength saving throw. Comfort to soil. And it's restrained. Okay. So it's just a strength saving throw. That's it. All right. So he's going to attack the... Which one? The one closest to him, in fact. He's going to make sure that that one doesn't get any closer. And that is going to be his strength saving throw, which means he's going to fail it. Yeah, no, his DC is way too high for him to... Yeah, with that roll. Okay, so he's going to fail it, and he's going to take... 2d6. Oh, wow. So he takes 10 points of damage, which may drop him. The problem is, wait, what happens if the damage that he receives is just enough to drop him to 0? Does he have to make his throw at all? The zombie to stay up?
I think as a zombie, yeah, I think getting reduced to 0 as a like zombie or whatever, I would treat that as dead for them. They're not thinking about making death saves. Like, generally anything that's not a player... or an important NPC, usually doesn't work on death saves.
Well, no, what I'm saying is it's going to bring him down to 0, but he has the ability to stay up at 1 hit point, but he has to roll, technically, 5 plus the damage over, which means that it's going
to
be...
he still has to roll it to get back up to 1, because if he's at 0, he's done.
Okay, yeah, no, he's...
just a zombie.
He's still going to be at 1 hit point, then. But he is restrained.
Invincible zombies.
Yes, they are technically very, very invincible at the moment. So he is restrained. He does some damage. Almost brings him down. So it is now the zombie's turn. So zombie number one, who has been, beat up really, really badly, is going to get to go. And he's going to make his throw, and he is going to miss. And he is going to... The second one is going to miss. Third one is going to miss. Fourth one is going to barely hit. And he's going to do... What is your damage again? Your damage is currently... Is it... Pretty sure it's just their strength. Yeah, so it's going to be just the one. Okay, so it's going to be only 3 points of damage. That's kind of crappy. 3 points of damage against this guy next to him. So we're going to bring him down by 3 points. All right, and then the fifth one. The fifth one is going to miss. Right, the zombies are just tanking, man. They're not doing much damage at all, but they are taking a lot of damage that you otherwise would be taking. So that's something. It is now Jurth's turn. He has to make a throw, and he does make it. So he's got one to him and one to the bad. One to the bad, one to the good. His turn is now done. It's now this guy's turn. Moving in, he's going to chop into a zombie. The same one that is being grappled by the stony hand he makes a swing at. He would definitely hit, and he will do 7 points of damage. Now, that's 7 over the top. It's 12 I have to roll. He rolls exactly 12 plus his con anyway, so the zombie is still alive. He's going to take another swing at him. And he will hit, and he will do 7 points of damage. So it's going to be 12 again. This time the zombie fails. Okay, the zombie is dead.
No!
That one, okay, it's basically, you can't get them back after they die, so...
Undead.
He's done. They finally tank out another zombie. Hurrah! That's his turn.
I wonder if we could go back to the Lich and get, like, a new set or something.
I don't know.
It's hard. Virtual dice.
He really doesn't... Telling me
with the furnace, but it doesn't help as much.
All right, so this one's going to do 10 points damage over the top of the one, so it's going to be 9.
Oh, it's pay respects. I got it wrong.
Damn. No, actually, he has to roll an 11. Okay, no, he fails. All right, so the second one dies. So you just lost 2 zombies. You got 3 left.
Yeah, I don't care about the second one as much.
All right, and he is going to...
with the first one.
It's the first one I was really close to.
Yeah. He's going to move in and take another swing and another one. And he's definitely going to hit. He's going to do 9 points of damage.
9 has a much better chance to take him out.
Yeah, but the thing is that it's only going to bring him down to...
this one still had hit points.
To 1 hit point, yeah. So the 9 points of damage only brings him down to 1 hit point. So that was unfortunate for him. All right, so that's his
turn. How big are the squares in this room?
Everything is 10-foot squares. Yeah. 10 feet by 10 feet.
Because sometimes I think it's 5 and it's 10, and sometimes I think it's 10 and it's 5. Yeah,
it doesn't help that zombies are just getting moved around as a cluster, so they're not really in locations and stuff like that.
But yeah.
Theoretically, each corner of the square is kind of like a 5-foot square.
Okay.
That's why I'm in the top left.
A 5-foot square.
KDS says
the squares on the map are 10-foot squares, so you have to treat sort of each corner as a 5-foot square.
You can fit 4 feet. Okay.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Eric, your turn.
Okay. Where are you going? I'm just going to come over here and, like, try and bust this guy out.
That is...
That's not what I'm doing. I clicked the wrong thing.
Okay.
Okay, so I hit him for 13. Thunderous crack, like, iron fangs.
Right, so this guy here, he gets 13 points of damage?
Yes, yeah, the guy I hit before that I had been holding.
Yeah, no, he definitely takes it.
He's still up there, and then I'll try and hit him again.
Okay. He will barely hit, and you do 18 points of damage. That really hurts.
Enough?
Nope, but he's still standing. He's really badly damaged, though. Tal, your turn.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, speaking of really badly damaged, Tal.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah, you are. Wow. Wow, Tal. How now, Brown Tal? Sorry.
God, Tao, no kidding. I mean, I can take my next action to heal.
I mean, I don't think there's any reason for me to just run away or anything. Because, I mean, you know, if you heal me now, or if I go down and you heal me after, it sort of kind of doesn't make a difference. And so it would be better if I could actually deal some damage. Hurt so what somebody. I'd like to do is come around, squeeze right over here, and stab the ever-living heck out of the spellcaster who covered me in mud.
All the things.
Yeah.
Okay.
The ever-living heck.
All the things.
Living.
And I'm going to use, like, all my luck, all everything to get this done. All right, 19. That hits, right?
I think so, because he, actually...
Yes.
Right, so...
Everybody think yes.
You come in with a dagger. You know for a fact it's about to hit. Strike, boom, but it gets deflected at the last minute by some sort of shield. Just bling, comes off the side.
Firestone.
Now, if it is a shield spell, I believe it lasts for one round. Mm-hmm. So he'll also be able to deflect my... I can take a bonus action to try to stab him again. But most likely that's going to cause a problem. So what I'm going to do instead is this. Give me a moment, because this is not an ability I use very frequently. So mm-hmm. I'm going to just have to reference it and make sure that's not the file I want to open. Where's my... Oh, yes, I moved it. Unearthed Arcana. Sonic's Mystic. So I can spend 5 action... Oh, I can spend an action point, or 5 power points to get Surge of Action, which gives me an additional action this turn. But I didn't realize I can only use it to do attack, dash, disengage, hide, or use an object. I can't use it to, like, use another one of my abilities. Because I was going to spend 5 power points to get another action, then spend some power points to, like, burn out his brain or use one of my magic items. But apparently I can't. What kind of horseshit is this?
Yeah, I mean, at the one hand, I can see the argument why that could be too strong. At the same time, though, you are burning through a bunch of points, so
but
I don't know.
Apparently I cannot. All right, so I will just use my bonus action to try to stab him again with my offhand weapon.
All right, so roll higher than...
Phenomenally
I'll let you know if you hit.
Shield.
No.
20?
Not currently going to make it.
Man, those shield spells are really, really annoying.
Yep.
All right, because they don't have to live beyond one fight anyway. They can just spend all the shields.
This is true.
Yeah. For PCs, it's way less effective.
Although, it does come in handy. Lisan, your turn.
You want to heal, or do I hit? Or attempt to hit?
I don't know. 6 of 1, 6 of the other. You know what? Just apply some damage. These guys are really nicely grouped up for you to do max damage.
What
will likely happen is you'll probably heal me and I'll probably go down anyway. Okay. So you can heal me next turn or something.
So are these guys close enough? These two close enough to hit, get that third shot in?
The two by the table should be.
Yeah. Oh. Basically, right. These two are close enough.
And, like, and the one that I was fighting this one. The one I was fighting is badly hurt, so you ought to be able to hit him.
If you hit the one in the middle, you can hit either one. Basically.
Okay, we'll go for the middle one twice, and I'll hit the one he's been mucking around on and hope that one more is enough to kill him. 18 hit?
18 will hit, albeit barely, and 12 points of damage?
Yes.
Not 122, 12, there we go.
28 hit, and no, hardly any damage. Same guy.
Okay, so minus 6. Okay.
And then this last one is the guy beside Eric, which
and
is a miss.
It is going to miss.
Yeah.
Frack.
Yep.
Best damage, and it misses.
Mm. Yeah. That's the way it goes, though. Yep. All right, so this guy is dead. I'm just going to go ahead and remove him. Gira is now, I don't know, I guess he's going to storm
inside.
Nobody's
down. Ooh.
So 1, 2, 3, 4. And he's basically, what he was doing is he was going for this guy. Then he notices off to the corner of his eye, he sees a mage. And that mage looks a lot squishier. If I can actually just click on him. Can I? Thank you. And I just want to spin.
He goes running in and goes,
hello! Wait, no, move. No. God damn it. Okay. This is the other thing, too. When it comes to stacking like this, getting there. Now then. Now that looks proper. It looks like a proper swing is about to happen. I don't know if it's going to be proper or not, but. D10! Wait, he has a bonus 5. Which means, again, what is this? So, yeah, I have to hit. No, okay. So, is he going to miss? Does he get 2 swings or just the one? No, he just... No, he gets... Multi... No, that's the wrong person. Look at the wrong person. He gets another swing. So, his first attack misses, though, and his second misses. All right. Gira takes 2 swings, and they both sort of like whoosh, whoosh. Actually, one almost hit, so it just gets deflected off of this invisible shield. Very, very disheartening. So now it's this guy's turn. He's really badly damaged, but he is definitely going to try to strike back against his oppressor that is following behind him.
Oppressor.
He's going to miss.
I'm oppressing you.
And he's going to miss again. I rolled a 7 and a 5. both against the main tank, which means that doesn't hit. All right, so now it's the caster's turn again. What the hell is he going to do?
Nuke us with another fifth level spell?
Well, there is some things he could do. I think he is going to, you know what? He's going to cast Shatter.
God damn it.
Although he does have...
At least that somebody, one's only a second level spell.
Somebody is in his melee range, though. What does that do again?
It doesn't. It does nothing if he's casting Shatter. It only if they're using a spell that has an attack roll, they would have disadvantage, just like a ranged person with a bow or something.
Okay, so this one's a freebie.
In fifth ed, you can just cast regular spells as long as there's no attack roll. There's no drawback at all. All
right. So well, he's going to do that, and he's going to cast it at a third level because he hasn't used his third level yet.
So what does Shatter do?
Shatter hurts like a son of a bitch.
Okay, you know what, Eric? As a reaction, Eric's going to be like, hey. Cut that out. And I'm gonna counterspell that.
No! What?
What? Oh, this is gonna be devastating.
Third level or lower, it's just counterspelled. I spent a third level spell to do it. I'm out of spell slots right now.
Right, okay, so he goes, Shatter! But as he's saying, he's like, it just he mouths it off and then nothing happens.
I just point to him and it's like, hey. Quit it. Just stare him down.
Careful, Deep Mac. No one likes a blue Magic the Gathering player.
Yeah.
You're just gonna make enemies out of the DM.
I don't think there's much danger of Eric becoming a blue mage.
Right. He's gonna take his move action after that, since that did not work, and he's gonna hide next to the He's going to stand next to the bed, in and away from the giant half-ogre that's scaring the shit out of him. But the problem is, the ogre is definitely going to get an attack of opportunity. So we're going to hope that that misses. The ogre is going to... Wait, this is his turn. He doesn't cast shield this turn. And he can't now either.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo.
That's going to hit.
Good.
Just barely, but it hits. So that's going to be his first damage, his second damage. Let's see, plus... What is your strength again? What am I adding here? Okay. Yeah. So that's going to do... Mathing right now is hard. So does 19 points of damage. That bloodies him. Like, he's going to basically do... He knows for a fact he's going to clear the room with this. Like, just he feels like... And then somehow he's silenced. Effectively. And then he runs away, and then he gets hit in the back with a giant pick or whatever, the axe or whatever that the gear. I forget what he's using right now. Is he using a glaive? What's he using? Battle axe. He is supposed to be using a battle axe. So the battle axe does strike him and cleaves into his armor.
Sweetness and light. Awesome.
All right. So that's that guy's turn.
Skelly says, I wonder when the others start to talk to Eric about his magical abilities. We tried early in, but he's kind of like, what? He doesn't even understand some of the things that are... He's in the dark and we can't, and he didn't get it.
There was clearly something about it that was just causing him to interpret whatever he was doing as if it were normal. Whatever deception, that veil was sort of like obstructing his awareness is starting to break down at this point.
Oh, good.
After the bust of fireball and shatter and stuff like that, he's starting to it's harder and harder to fool himself into thinking it is making sense.
Yeah, the fireball was a bit of something. Up until now, I just assumed that you're sort of like, you know, you're sort of blessed by Opensa or something like that. You're just a little bit zen, you know, you've got that mental control, exactly the same source of power that Tau has, is sort of what she's been assuming. Fireball is a little different. But other than that, it's like, I don't know. Seems totally legit. I don't know what you're talking about.
Alcohol and magic are the same word. That's awesome, right?
Alright, Jirth. Jirth just made his saving throw again, so he's got two to the good, one to the bad.
Good, okay.
It is now this particular guy right here. It's his turn. He is going to, honestly... He's going to take a swing at this zombie that was almost... As far as he can tell, this thing should be dead now. Right? Except he's going to... How do you miss a zombie? That's how you miss a zombie. I don't know, maybe... The last hit almost... Sorry, what was that?
the smell repels you so bad you can't look at it.
He looks away and he takes a swing. I like that better than
I was
going to say.
Walking Dead. You aim, you look away, and you hit for a long time and you hope to keep it.
His second swing will connect, though.
So your Walking Dead technique is basically...
Pretty much. That's how I actually played the whole first series and most of the second. Is you kind of know they're coming, you sort of aim really quick, and you just look away and you click a lot and you hope you don't die. It was I would gag. It was all horrible.
Given the saving throws that this guy has to make, he did get hit on his second strike. He has to roll at least an 8 to avoid it, and he rolls a 6. So this zombie is also dead. You lost another one.
Damn. We're going to need a fresh set.
There he is. He's gone. And, right, so that's his turn. He gets to swing twice.
To the big guy yet.
Now it's this guy. He's going to take 2 swings against another zombie. They're clearing out their zombies right now. That's definitely going to hit. He is doing 7 points of damage to this one here. So it takes 7. And he's going to get another swing. And he crits. So that's going to be 3 and 5 and 4, 6,
someone's
12
asking me a question.
Points of damage. Which brings him over by 9, which means he has to roll at least an 11. Which he
Someone
does not.
Asking,
another zombie's dead.
Magic user walked away because, I mean, Tao had been right there too. Did Tao get an attack of opportunity as well? Or had Tao moved back?
Oh, hey, yeah.
Oh, right. Yeah, no, Tao, you get an attack of opportunity. Sorry.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Remember, I'm pretty sure attacks of opportunity are reaction, which shouldn't affect this at all. Like, it's not like Tao did a reaction or anything.
27. Shield this.
Yep. So 8 points of damage.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you say 8? I think you mean... 8 plus explode. F this guy. F this guy right in the eye.
All right. So actually what ends up happening, instead of him running and getting to this bed, he still gets to the bed, right? Except he gets to the bed in a few pieces. Okay. The psionic energy, he cannot contain it.
It's like as he's walking away, it's like building up inside him.
Yeah. He starts to stumble, stagger, and then he just starts to... crumble.
Oh, it just blows him against the wall. That's why he got that far.
What's that terrible movie, like Fist of the North Star or whatever?
Yes, that's the one.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
Woo-hoo! That kind of exploded. Yeah, that works. Yeah. Nice. So this guy is dead. He's
that's
done.
Really
Absolutely
good.
Finished.
That's really good.
Oh, man. And he was going to do so well with that shatter. That shatter was going to be devastating. In fact, that's, Tao, you was going to take the brunt of
it. Looked like he was bad. Like, Tao was low, saving wouldn't have helped. It was like, just cut that out.
That was going to be really bad. So it's the next guy's turn. He's going to take another swing at Mr. Zombie. Actually, did I already use him? Did I attack with him?
Running out of zombies.
I already have with him, probably. Didn't I? Oh, no, I got distracted now. Have I used... Anybody viewing right now, did I use this guy? This last guy, have I used him? Or did I use him to kill a zombie?
Don't know.
I think I used somebody to kill a zombie.
Had you moved through yet? I don't know. I mean, yeah, I don't know.
Somebody has to know. Somebody would definitely know.
That player...
Yes, I've already used him.
Okay.
Okay. Yes, you did. Okay. All right. So he's done. All right. It is now Eric's turn.
Yes, he's used.
Okay.
Yes, he's used. Okay.
I'll point over at the bloody bed over there. It's like, hey, does this place have turnover service or what? And then I'm gonna hit this guy with the bust. But I think I'm getting tired of the. I think the bust has been used so much at this point. I'm gonna have to.
The bust is
that.
A bust.
Yeah.
I don't know.
18 hit for 16 damage.
That will the guy in front of you.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he's toast.
Okay. Good. Excellent. So then, I smash him with the bust, and I just kind of let it go. Like, I guess it cracks as I'm, like, taking him out. It's like, this thing has been used too much. Then I'm going to grab one of the chairs near me and just spin around and try and, like, whack the next guy with it.
Awesome.
Stepping forward. Whack.
Yeah. Busted. Looks like he's going to miss.
Yeah.
That is going to just miss. In fact, you know, it's a chair leg, right? You tried to hit with the entirety of the chair, but you basically just get the edge of the chair leg, and it snaps off. And you just basically do no damage. It's unfortunate.
Yeah.
So that's your turn. Tao, your turn.
All right. I spent my bonus action imbuing the chair. It's an important detail. Otherwise, it would do less damage and stuff.
Whoa. I just love that line. I spend my bonus action imbuing the chair.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what?
Well, it's a three-legged chair now? Right now. It still stands up. It's imbued with magic. It's fine.
Yeah.
It's like a six-legged chair. It's so stable.
Are either one of these two guys bloody?
It's immune to rust, acid, and corrosion, because those are properties of the weapon that I'm imbuing it with.
Are either one of these two guys bloodied?
No, these other two guys, they're still pretty fresh. Technically
fresh. Not as fresh as the zombies.
Fresh.
I don't want to use any more power points, I think. But I guess I can still move up and do some stabby stab. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here, jump up on the table.
Of course. Awesome.
I have the high ground now.
Yep. Acrobatics roll.
You're jumping up and down, you get a crit. Oh, no, that's Minecraft. Sorry. Yeah. Jump up and down.
You want me to actually do an acrobatics roll? I can. There you go. So, am I going to get advantage on my attacks then?
Yeah, well, technically you have the high ground, whatever. Fine.
Good.
I'll let you have it. I was trying to really toast you on that one, didn't it?
If the table is slightly uneven, like they normally put like a couple of playing cards underneath one of the table legs, but it got dislodged in the combat, so now the table's kind of wobbly.
It's wobbly. It's moving around, you know, or maybe the zombie just kind of like bumped it or something. Yeah, I don't know. You miss.
For like a couple of points, maybe.
Oh my god, no,
not if it's good. It's all bad.
It turns out that, you know, standing on the table, which makes you a little bit taller than your enemy, and you're using a dagger, which is short, so you just get further away. And it doesn't work. All right. It looked cool, though.
It looked cool.
Yeah. All right, Lasan, your turn.
Okay, we'll aim for the guy in the middle there, I guess. He's the one that's hurt the most, right?
Oh, wait, did I not? Zombie Rampage. Did I click off the zombie? No, the zombie.
And I missed.
Oh, the zombie. I removed the zombie. I have a zombie left to go, and I think I actually didn't do the zombie last time, did I?
Oh, my God. We are rolling so bad.
This is terrible. Is the other guy within range of a third attack?
Yes.
Wish me luck, folks. And...
Yay! You hit! Which one? You're this one here, right?
That one, yeah.
Yeah, okay, so he takes 9 points of damage.
God.
All right, so pew pew, and then finally you stick one. All right, so it's this guy. Did I not use the zombie here? The zombie rampage, where I was hoping to roll a 1. Have room. Can I have that room when you're done? Yeah. I needed to store pickled herring. Well, sure. You know what? Fine. You can have it. All right, so this guy's going to turn around. I'm going to say the zombie is maybe stunned because all his friends are dead. So he's not going to get to go this turn, if indeed I was supposed to make him go this turn anyway. So we've got Gira turns around, who's still wounded. He is going to take a mighty swing at, the one closer to Tao. And, whoa, he's going to hit. Like, easily hit. So that's going to be... And then... Wait, no, I'm rolling again. Stupid. It's only 2. So it's... So 11 points of damage on his first swing. And he is going to hit, maybe try again. He will barely hit, although for minimum... minimum there, but he gets one more. Minimum again, so... 5 points of damage. The second hit is poop. Gira is done. Now it is the retort from this guy. No, he's dead, so we're going to move him out of there. This guy is dead, so we're moving him out of there. Jirth has to make another saving throw, and...
What?
I rolled a 1.
He's dead.
He's dead.
Are you serious?
Yep. He's instantly dead. I just rolled a 1.
How did you get 1?
1 doesn't insta-kill you, but it does make 2 death saves.
Yeah, that's it.
And he already had 1.
Yeah. So, yeah. Okay, just checking.
Jirth is dead.
No!
Like, dead.
Although,
done.
Diplomatically, this does, like, simplify some of our situation here.
This is true. Jirth is dead. Bye-bye, Jirth.
We were not trying to do that, but it is technically convenient for us, assuming that we can get through the next couple of fights without him.
Oh, we've lost
I can't use luck on him. That doesn't work, guys.
No.
Yeah. I don't know if I would anyway.
All right. Well, it is now this guy's turn. He turns to I'm guessing he's going to attack the big guy in front of him. The Lummix. Actually, I'm rolling the wrong die for damage. So let's get the right one. Oh, never mind. He misses anyway. Second swing. Oh, maybe crit. Actually, it is a crit because it's auto-confirmed. So that's 6 and...
Statistically, it's quite
11 points of damage. There it is. He is, Gira is really badly damaged. Like, really badly damaged. And it is now the second guy's turn, who is going to go after Gira, who is going to miss on the first swing. Somehow he misses. And he's going to roll worse on the second. So, yes. Gira is lucky. He is still standing. Eric, your turn.
He's an ex-ogre.
He's an ex-ogre.
Well, I'm going to...
It's all the fault of our chair. Supposed
I'm
going to
try and chair this guy. Try and use the chair to, like, wrangle him and pull him away, probably. So I'm going to hit him for 12. Nice. Guy next to the table. I'm going to try and grapple him as a bonus action.
Yep.
13.
Okay. He succeeds. He does not get grappled.
Okay. Well, I tried. I guess I just have to finish him then. Hit him again.
And missed.
Nope.
He's still alive. Boom. Excellent. Tyler, your turn.
I'm cheering as hard as I can.
Cheering is caring.
I'm gonna carefully step down off the table.
Carefully. Okay. Roll an acrobatics check. No, it's just
it's all ogre now.
Oh, it's all ogre now. Oh my god, come on!
Right. That's not gonna hit. And
19.
For 1 point of damage. Right.
Yeah, but the important thing is that the blow lands, so rather than have any other fatalities. Oh my god, there's still two people standing though.
Oh man.
Whatever, I gotta go and Sonic strike this guy. I was hoping to avoid spending any more resources.
Big one. Damn.
Yeah. Despite getting expensive.
No.
Yeah.
There's nothing absolutely... There's nothing... It's funnily enough, there's nothing gory about this guy's death. He just... You ever seen Star Trek? You know how they get hit with a phaser and they just, like, disintegrate into, like, nothing?
Yeah.
I'm just going to say...
When you said it's a level 10.
That's what happens to him. He gets hit so hard that he just turns into air.
That's how all the enemies, well, not all of them, but that's how a lot of the enemies in Star Trek Online die, which I played yesterday, which was very fun.
I watched some of it, whatever I could.
I haven't played that in a while.
Yeah, it's super good.
It is.
All right, so that's Tal's turn. He disintegrates, literally, somebody. Lisan, your turn.
Well, we just got the one fella left. I guess I'll shoot at him.
Quill's constant waste of pee-pee.
In case he doesn't die.
That's a very interesting phrase. That's going to hit, yep. And hit again, so 18 points of damage. He takes it. One, boom. Two, boom. But he's still standing.
He's still standing.
Gira! Gira gets to go. Roll the right damage.
Gira, don't get dead.
Gira will miss on his first swing. And we'll catch him on a second, so that's... So that's only going to be 12 points of damage, so he's still standing. All right, it is now, well, oh, Jirth, damn. All right, it is now his turn. This guy, I'm moving him out of there. So it's the guy that Gira just took a swing and hit, is going to swing back and hit. Okay, that's 7, and hit again, holy shit.
God damn it.
And so 7 is going to bring him down, though. Let's see if, I think, yeah, 7 brings him down, so he probably won't attack him again. These guys aren't all about coup de grace.
At this point, surviving would be an accomplishment.
Yeah, he's still, okay, he brings down the big brute, and does he run anywhere? There's nowhere for him to run. He has to run through people. This is not good for him. I'm gonna say Gira's down at the moment. What would he do? You know what? He's devout. He's gonna stand and fight. If he doesn't bring you guys down, somebody else will, right? So it's going to be... I'm just going to transfer his attack, which would also... You know, you have 20. No.
Is he 20?
Yeah, yeah, no. He just barely misses you. That's his second hit, so that's his turn. Which is interesting because he moves over to you, and now your turn.
Yep.
Good.
You look tired.
The zombie's turn. Wait, so the zombie. I forgot the zombie.
Okay.
Let me go for the zombie. The zombie's going to move in.
I let the zombie go. Sure.
Zombie is going to take. Oh, we're going to die. Zombie is going to take a swing. And miss. Yeah, he misses.
So I missed my first attack.
Okay, yep.
I tried to give this guy a seat, but he just won't. He's just not having it. No, that's not very good.
It's two misses.
16.
Two
misses.
Nope.
Yep.
Tao, your turn.
Alright, well, I'll...
Oh, now Tao.
You know what? I'm just going to go here, and I'm just going to try to kill him with my brain. I'm going to have, like, maximum safety going on here. They have a pretty bad saving throw versus brain, so... He's got to do...
What is
his
saving throw versus brain?
An int saving throw.
Oh, yeah. No, that's...
Actually, I think my damage might have gone...
Bot sphere.
Isn't? Yeah. So he basically has no bonuses whatsoever. So I have to go DC 14. So basically I have to roll a 14. I roll a 4. That's not happening. So how much damage? 8?
8.
Okay.
Woo!
He's still standing. His brain is a little... His brain is much like his body. He's in real bad pain.
He's just mildly concussed, but yeah. he's gonna keep fighting because he doesn't know how like brain. He doesn't know the long term effects of that concussion.
Okay, never mind.
Whoa, there we go.
He's dead. Okay, fine. You know what? You release an arrow and it doesn't even stay in him. It just goes through, hits the wall on the other side. Fine. He's dead.
No flavor text, just fine. Okay.
He drags his heart out with it. All right.
There. That's amazing, yeah.
Boop, 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 boop. Still beating in the back wall. All right, that's disgusting.
I don't think that's how hearts work, but sure, whatever.
Yeah, no.
This zombie goes back up to... I don't know enough about the human body.
All right, this zombie's just shuffling around, looking for his friends.
Oh, he's all alone!
The one lone zombie.
Poor little John.
I'm gonna go listen to the door here and just see if there's anything going on outside.
All right,
I'm gonna sit here and spurt blood on the ground.
Yeah.
No, we're done. Not be healing. I'm on the way.
All right, so Eric, you're listening to the door right now.
Yeah.
And the door says to you.
The door says to you.
Nothing, actually, because the door doesn't talk. That's fine. So there's nothing happening on the other side of that door.
Oh, crap. Okay, and then you got a spell on you there, Tao. And where's my other one? And this one.
It's a lot of blood.
Only 15.
It's spreading out now. It's spreading out. Oh, the blood's going everywhere. Oh, God.
Technically, just barely not bloody.
Check the arrow slits while they're doing that.
Oh, yeah, good idea. Look
at those
bad boys.
Okay, wait a minute. Was this still part of the last day? How many? Did we take a rest? I'm wondering how many spells I have. Okay, I have no idea.
We did take a full sleep before we did the big fight on the bridge.
Yeah.
And then this is the next fight after that.
Yeah.
Okay, so I should still have... Okay.
Save Gira. Gira's dead, man. There's nothing to save.
No, Gira's...
Gira's alive. Jareth's dead.
Jareth is dead, yeah.
Yes, I got confused. Yes, Gira. Oh, Gira's down too. Yeah, yeah. Better patch him up.
It's 2d8. Roll 2.
So what am I actually seeing here through these arrow slits? Like, just basic wall? Or, like, it looks like there's something there. I can't tell.
Yeah, no, it's just a wall. Oh, you mean the other one. You have another arrow slit. One second.
You do... Oh, great. An extra 3. Well, that's freaking good. Well, I got you for 18, Tao. Best I can do for you.
Oh, an 18?
Yeah. Sorry. And then gear is down. What kind of shape are you in, Eric?
Oh, 18 instead
of
15.
I'm basically fine.
Yeah, 18 instead of 15, yeah.
Take any real damage this fight. They just killed everyone else. I wasn't in the area because I was inside the room when they were trying to nuke everyone outside the room, and then.
So I'll go patch up Gira as best we can. What do we get for him? Something better? One hopes.
Well, no, not much. So you give Gira what? 8 points of damage?
8. Yeah. Healed?
Okay. Yeah. No, he's up.
Yeah, he's up. He's not moving very well.
No, he's really badly
damaged. And I'll add. That?
Wow.
Oh, come on.
You guys still have potions, to my knowledge, too.
We had
how many hit dice does Gira have? Because that healer feat was only set to 3 hit dice. So you should gain an extra hit point for every hit dice he has more than 3.
That's
right. Right. Actually, I'll
thank you. Yeah.
And actually, anyone else who you healed with the healer feat just now should have gained an extra 3 hit points because we're level 6 and it's just doing plus 3. And...
it wasn't changed last week. Okay, then you guys get
the plus 4. It's got D6 plus 4, that's fixed. And then the 3 there should be like our level.
So yeah, I would do another, another plus 5.
Okay. Yeah, we just don't know how many hit dice or levels Gira has because he's an NPC.
You know, I never actually leveled him up.
Yeah, I never knew what his
I leveled him up, but I never actually gave him his extra hit dice.
That's what happened to me in the previous level.
So, I mean, you guys met him as, like, 6. He's basically 5 right now.
Because he would have had an extra whole level of hit dice?
Yeah.
Cool.
So he would have gained another 2 hit points from that healer feat.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to level him up proper, which means he also should get an extra, just an actual hit die. So I'm gonna go ahead and roll his hit die.
Hit points. Yeah.
I'm gonna roll it. So he gained 6, actually, so that's not bad. 6 to his max. So he's gonna be at 62. Oh, wait, except gains 2. So that's, he went up by 6. I mean, he went up by 8 and 4, which gave him 12. But then he goes up by how much? 2 more, right? Yeah. So he's at 14 currently. Okay, he's at 14 hit points. Still badly wounded, but he's still up.
Yeah, this place just keeps going and going.
It does. It's a lot going on. Also... despite all the rage, you're still just a rat in a cage. No, sorry. Despite the fact that you guys have just had a massive fight, because you have you're looking out, you can hear it quite resonatingly. The louder sounds of again like the anvil working, like bang, bang, bang. It's like resounding sounds of a hammer on anvil.
I'm guessing we need at least a short rest here in order to function.
I think so.
Oh, and the doors do open inward, so you can barricade.
We can barricade it. We can watch very easily through the arrow slits.
Yep.
I mean, unless someone decides to go and cast, like, freaking transmute rock through the arrow slit.
Funnily enough, you also have beds. And this bed's too hard. This bed's too soft. This bed is right.
Of course.
So, yeah. And yes, we can mourn Jirth, although maybe Gira will mourn him more, I don't know.
Actually, no, Gira, here's the funny thing. Gira.
Yeah, Gira sort of was in the know the whole time.
Yeah, Gira knows, right? In fact, Gira, once he realizes that Jirth is dead, he turns back. You know what, he goes out and he looks around. He's like, he just staggers over there and looks out, walks over to him, and takes his foot. Doesn't even reach down, just takes his foot and kind of like pushes at his shoulder. Okay, and then turns back around. He's like, wait, sorry, move him out of the way. I want this guy. Moves back inside or whatever, and looks at you, Tal, specifically, because you know, winky face. He's the one who winked at you, first of all. He looks at you and goes, good. Now I don't have to kill him.
Damn! I say it out loud. I'm like, damn!
Yep.
And I get, like, a whole level of respect and also, like, something else.
Yeah, he's been trained really good by Goblin.
At the same time,
you know, he's learned a lot from Goblin, hanging out with a Goblin.
Yeah. Oh yes, that's right. Loot the bodies. 21.
Yeah, we do have to see if this priest has anything. Although usually they don't seem to. And if Jirth had anything of value.
Well, Jirth didn't have anything on him, but if you do recall, you know, in his room there were like containers and stuff like that. You don't know what's in them because you never checked, but
Up back up top,
yeah.
We're gonna loot these bodies.
Okay, so so that's going to be I got 1, 2, 3, 4 5. Alright, so you get you find 5 gold.
Woo!
Sorry.
5 gold.
It was it. That's all. Sorry. That's all.
Which is today, folks.
And that guy read our treasure. We could have gotten a second scroll of Transmute Stone, but no. You had to use it.
Right.
He still has another one, though.
Does have keys for the cells and stuff?
Does he not? Oh, no, he doesn't.
Jailer, right?
What's that, sorry?
Jerth was a jailer, so he might have keys.
Yeah, we were going to let out the prisoners. He was the one in charge of that place.
Yeah, you can rescue the prisoners now. Yeah, it's true.
Okay.
Yeah, because, you know, nobody works for Jerth anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, so we're taking the organization a short rest.
Killed.
So we're taking a short rest, I guess.
I guess we'll throw the bodies outside. Move them out by like the broken by the statue over here. We'll make a nice pile.
Okay. So Jerth, this guy.
From what I understand, the one zombie that's still alive, like full heals from what's his face's power, right? But the other ones that are gone are just like gonna stay gone, stay dead.
Oh yeah, we could throw them down the hill, down the cliff over here. But I kind of like the idea of like making a pile of gore to like, if anyone else comes over here, they're gonna be afraid.
Oh, down in the chasm, you mean? Or
we could throw them down in the chasm. But
interesting thing, if you do it over here, you're piling up a bunch of bodies around the statue of Ogrimmok,
I don't want it to look like sacrifice.
No. Yeah, the god of earth.
We did smash the face of the statue earlier.
Yeah. Interestingly enough, though, the face is back.
What?
Yeah.
What?
This is his domain, man. You are in his domain.
Those guys have like a cantrip that shapes stone to some degree, right? Yeah. I think it's only temporary. Like it lasts like an hour or something. Yeah. But...
smash it again.
Yeah, we smash it again. And yes, I want to make like this. Yeah.
Eric will smash it again. Smash the face again.
Are you doing it with your pick, though? Or are you just doing it?
Well, I'm doing it with a chair, which is imbued with the power of the pick.
Oh, this is true. All right. So you know what? So you bring up the chair. This is so stupid. Yeah. You bring up the chair, imbued with magic. And, you crash across the face. Where are you aiming?
Face, yeah.
Face, okay. Crash across the face again. And the face shatters and breaks off once again.
Okay.
And there's a rumble in the ground.
Okay.
There wasn't a rumble when I broke it before using the imbued like bust.
No. Yeah. So there's a rumble this time.
Okay.
But then it settles. And that's it.
Ooh.
Okay, let's lock ourselves in the room and do a short rest.
Okay. Actually, can we take a 5-minute break while we do this?
Oh, yes, absolutely. Take a 5-minute break. Everybody, if you have to go pee, if you want a beverage, go grab a beverage, and we'll be right back. Moment.
I've had a lot of coffee.
Yay. Let's go relief. We need relief.
Like a pot, big pot so far. So, yeah. Time for more tea and other things. So, see you in a minute.
Yep.
Greetings, everybody. We have returned, and we're about to begin again as the second portion of Sunday Morning Heroes is big... Wait, where's my thing? Oh, there it is. Returning with Quilly Team.
Hey, folks. Sorry, just having a sip of Diet Coke there.
A kiss for luck is also here.
And we'll have a sip of tea. Hi, guys.
And Demonac.
Greetings.
And I'm having a sip of water. I know I'm boring. All right, I'm going to go ahead and bring this back up there, and you guys are there. That's good. And let's get some FaceTime continuum happening. And 3, 2, 1, and faces. There we go. All around. Perfect.
Caught with the tea.
Yes. Caught with a tea. There's worse ways to be caught. Having a tea is also always good.
Here's
always
that. Yes.
So we got a weird reaction from re-smashing the statue.
Yep.
To take a short rest, and we're no longer going to get the achievement for completing the quest with all zombies intact.
yeah, unfortunately.
Let's
that
reload.
Was really hard. I think we need to optimize our party more.
You guys want
to
save scum? Yeah.
I'm gonna, since we're short resting, I'm gonna burn some hit dice here.
If we're gonna short rest, I'm gonna use my second wind, which I hadn't used yet, to regain.
I can give you another healy thing. I think I'm gonna assume that I used at least a couple of spells after the last fight, and then two this time, so I've only got two spells left. Okay, but well,
I'm at full hit points, and it does refresh the cooldown on your first aid for the next fight, but we should be able to full heal ourselves with hit dice at this point.
Yeah, I don't need any healing at all.
What about Gira? Is anybody doing anything with him?
One hit die.
Well, Gira can spend his hit dice to full heal himself as well.
Right.
Yeah, as far as Gira goes, you have to tell me. I have no idea how many hit dice he has or stuff. So.
Oop. Okay. He actually has. So he's gonna. I get to full heal then. Or, Vinalida, hello, and thank you very much for that display of generosity. $20.
You roll your hit dice and heal that many plus your con modifier.
Okay, so that's okay.
So you could, and you can spend your hit dice one at a time to top yourself up.
At this point, I'm rolling stupid well. Yeah, no, he's going to be at full.
Yeah, well, usually you can fill yourself up. I mean, mathematically.
Yeah, well, I just roll max on 3. Roll. So no, he's going up to maximum. So what is his maximum? 62, I think. All right, so we have a fresh Gira. Hello and welcome, Terra Keen. Thank you very much for that follow. Very good. So generosity this morning is outstanding. Very much appreciated. So what are you guys gonna do? You've got what? You've got one zombie, one half ogre to move in. Yeah. You still hear the tinking coming in and echoing about the hallway.
From out in the hallway, south of us.
Yeah, somewhere. Basically off in this direction, you hear it best.
Okay. Right.
Why you roll again if he rolls good? What do you mean? Why you roll again if he rolls good?
I don't know what it means.
You gotta roll like...
I don't know.
I rolled several times.
Misunderstanding how hit points, dice work.
Yeah, I rolled several times. System of Cyclops zombies needs to be developed in combat. Oh, so like, you know, you need your forward shock zombies, right, to be replaced with your, secondary ranks and stuff.
Yeah, we'll make sure to have the remaining zombie stay in a very tight formation with himself.
this last one, yes.
Until it all falls apart, you know, that's what happens.
Totally should. Yeah. So, so everybody's fully healed? Everybody's good?
Yep.
We're good.
Yep.
So,
should we crack open this door, or do you want to go around down?
I kind of like the idea of going around, because we shouldn't have to open any doors.
I like it. All right.
We'll see if it connects up with this one. But
okay.
Theoretically, if we're opening fewer doors, we're hopefully making less noise. I don't know.
Okay, so from here you get 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Yeah, you got a good vision of what the hell is happening over here. So let's just go ahead and open this up. What is your overall distance you can see in the dark?
I'm 30. He's 120.
Yeah, I can see 120 if I poke around.
Okay, so, all right. So 120. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. Wait, no, what am I doing? It's 10. It's by tens. Shit. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 10 and 20. Jesus. All right, so basically all the way to there. That's a long-ass way to see.
Yeah, his vision is ridiculous.
It is abnormal for some reason.
Gonna see all the way because it has to cross through here. Right. Very good. Basically up to here.
Oh,
yeah. Bye. There you go.
That's
I did not expect that.
Oh.
No kidding.
That looks like it's really going someplace then.
Huh. What about to the left?
Is that a walkway across, or is it separating it into sort of two chasms?
No, that's a walkway across. You can go across that.
Okay. You can go underneath, in other words. Yeah. Like it's connected there.
It's, okay. Yeah, so it's like a bridge and not just a wall that we would be crossing the top of.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what about to the left?
Oh, right. Sorry. Yeah. To the left, you have... Actually, I guess you can see all the way around again. Because you can see forever beyond. 5, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Yeah, whatever. So you can see all the way across. So you're going to start there, and you're going to go all the way to there.
To where? Oh, here we go.
That was unexpected, too.
Stairs? Are those going down or up?
Those are going down.
Okay. Oh my god, there's another level? What?
Of course there is.
I think they're going down to a lower part on this. I don't think it's another map, right?
Should we go and check to the left? Like we can check, say, this hallway over here.
I think we're gonna try and see what's going on, because we do want to see where the other door in that room we came from went, just to make sure that it does match up.
Yeah, okay. I think we gotta snoop a little bit here.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Moving that way, so that means you guys can see again.
Something in the other room, just waiting for us to get quiet, so it could come barreling up behind us. That's not good.
We can do it like this, basically. There you go.
God damn, this place is huge.
Yep.
Same.
And then over here.
Oh, okay. Sorry. I will show you from here.
Sort of creeping around a little bit.
Does it?
Bryce says, "I will show you the world
down in the deeps of the chasm."
And monsters.
So, to the south, we see another door, and then it looks like it's opening up into another big, big open some darn thing, or wider than the hallway, obviously. And it looks like just to the west of us here too, just where you are, Tao. It looks like it's going to open up, doesn't it?
I think so. Oh my god!
Oh,
okay, there's
okay.
a whole other
like
level.
Level.
Okay, let's not go that way yet.
I don't want to do that yet. We don't have enough. I've only got 7 healing kits left. We don't want to do that one yet.
Yeah, I'm nearly out of power points. I can do my super stab twice more, but that's it.
Yeah, I get back my spell slot, so I'm actually at pretty close to full everything. Technically, I've used one of my daily shatters from Iron Fang, but...
Yeah.
I've lots of stuff, but if you guys run out of stuff and I have all my stuff, that doesn't work.
Yeah, Warlock has super sustain.
Doesn't help that I took, like, none of the damage last fight, despite running into the room first.
That's
true, that's weird.
Oh, okay, sorry. Interestingly enough, I almost forgot to tell you, while you guys were standing right here and looking down this long chasm, You were able to actually, even Lisan. Lisan's better at the whole perception than anything. Lisan, when you were coming around and you got around
this
right
is,
around
here. Yeah, this has become a favorite thing, so I should be able to.
Yeah.
Something, right? Are there tracks? Are there something?
You notice specifically the sound of that ant is really, really loud to you at this particular point, and you can almost swear you know exactly where it's coming from.
Which is?
It's coming from. You see the ledge here? There's a lip. It's coming from here. Like whatever.
And that. Now, remember the ledge that the guy we threw off? That was like an open room.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's possible that this door over here is leading into the same area as this ledge or whatever.
That's that, yeah.
I mean, there's not a whole lot of space here, so it might not, but it might.
shoot. And we can hear noise in there.
Oh, yep. Well, yeah, the resounding.
We know somebody's there then.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like it's easy for us to get to this ledge. I mean, we probably could do it with climbing checks. Mm. Also, it's possible that we could go and stand, say, here and then range attack anything that's in there. But that doesn't look like a very, like, safe area for us to be fighting from.
Not super safe.
Like, if we want to see what's in there, it might be this door. Might be the way to do it. Although, if we're going to do that, what we should do is go down this hallway and just peek around the corner and see what the heck's going on there.
Because it's open, yeah.
And I'm wondering about
How about somebody stealthier? How about one of you two who are stealthier do that?
I was going to say, this might be a situation for me to move down here.
Okay, one second. Let me just...
Leave the accordions behind.
Yeah. Oh! Hey, shots fired! Shots fired. All right, so, yeah, you're moving down to there. Give me a stealth check.
I'm going to luck that one. I mean, it's funny that I still get a 12, right? When I roll a 1, I still get a 12.
Yeah.
But I'm going to luck. Apparently, we did not, that short rest did not resolve our horrible, horrible rolls. I can't. There you go, 18.
There you go.
I got plus 11. I should be able to stealth like crazy, but apparently I found the accordion.
18, aka not one.
Yeah, no, yeah. Okay, so you get there to that particular area. Nothing seems to happen.
Yes, Ben, I'm totally stealthy. I've got really high dex. It'll be fine.
I took luck just so I didn't have to worry about accordions, because I knew that kind of crap would happen.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hang head in shame again. Lady Luck, improve your rolls. One tries, right?
You can see 30, you say, right?
Yes.
20, 30. Oh, so I went too far. So I'm going to bring... Well, that's okay. It's fine. You can sort of make it out. Right. Bam.
There's the cuckoo. Ooh! Oh.
All right. The important thing was just that this room is empty.
Hmm.
Although the other door is interesting, but... And it's interesting that there's kind of, like, natural wall over here. Also, yeah. I don't know what's going on there. Is this, like, is this moss or mold or something?
Actually, I have some text I can read for this, actually.
Ooh, flavor text!
Yeah.
Yay!
Like trouble. Yeah.
So, water fields, a rectangular marble basin in the middle of this hall.
It actually looks like a pool table.
Actually, yeah, it looks like an actual pool. Sorry. And the walls display an ancient... Oh, man, I'm gonna sound stupid because I don't know how to actually pronounce that. It's not a fresco. It's F-R-I-E-Z-E.
Oh, freeze.
Is it just freeze?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Okay. And the walls display an ancient freeze...
It's not like fresco.
...that circles the room. The freeze depicts woodland images of deer... bears, and game fowl, along with parties of dwarven hunters. The southeast corner of the room is badly damaged, and the walls there are a little more than rubble.
Hmm.
There's another door.
There's nobody in the room, though. That's the big important part. And what's the little fuzzy bit on the southwest part of the pool?
It's just damage.
Yeah, it's just rubble.
Just
the ground's been smacked up a little bit.
Yep.
Yeah.
Can you see whatever the hall or the opening to the east? Can you?
Yeah,
I could sneak up over there.
Yep.
Be quiet.
I will need another stealth check.
Oh boy.
Be stealthy. Be ever so stealthy.
Not another one.
Oh my god!
That's what happens when you call it.
do I use my final luck point? Jesus Christ!
Do you even have one left?
I have one more. I used one in the fight. I used one right now.
The odds of this.
You didn't use one last session?
Apparently not, no.
The chat is asking, has anyone ever actually explained to Lisanne that moving stealthily means moving without making noise?
Well, there's that. Nobody
I think
actually
it's contagious, guys. I'm just saying.
Okay. All right, so you stealth by. And everything seems fine. All right, so we're going to go ahead and reveal this next area. 10, 20, 30.
Yeah, I borrowed Lassan's accordion.
I should just carry it myself. I know you guys are trying to help me carry it, but maybe I should hang on to it myself.
Yeah, I burned all my luck that it would be better to have in combat. Fine, I'm sure we're not going to fight anything the rest of the session.
Oh, no, of course not.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
All right, well, I mean, scooch up a little bit more.
Okay.
So you kind of wonder if that connects to that walkway, and then it goes south again. Oh, my God, this place is a freaking maze.
Yes.
And what's to the east?
I mean, this is as far as I'm going to go, but yeah. I assume this just connects up to the ledge.
It looks like
Oh, right. Yeah. Actually, you can see, yeah, because you moved up to there. One second.
What you want to see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you will see up to there. Good enough.
Okay. So what I'll do is I'll come back here and just peek around the corner and give the symbol for, like, all clear to Eric.
Which is like... Yeah. Okay. All
right. Start moving along, I guess. We aren't checking the other way, but yeah.
Stealthily? Do we have to stealth this hallway, guys?
Oh my God, I thought you just got, like, attacked by something. I thought these guys just popped out of the shadows.
Yeah, no, everything's fine.
Yeah, no, we're playing Doom. Like, you check ahead and you scout out, everything looks clear, and then you take a step and a bunch of stuff warps in behind you. Like,
yeah, it's a computer game. Like, you clear the air, you confirm the area is clear, but then, like, stuff spawns from a trigger. You're like, really? Come on, game.
Yeah.
Okay, so you want me to make a stealth check to see how I get here?
right, stealth check, yeah. By the door, please, yes.
Okay, I clicked it. I don't know if it's going to happen.
Eventually.
Exactly.
More than likely. And three, and two, and one, and...
Face?
Anytime? No? I'm going to click it again, and I'm going to get a much better roll on the second one.
Oh, there's...
Okay, didn't take the first pick. So I actually end up with a 9, because again, I have disadvantage from wearing heavy...
All right. So there's that resounding hammer on anvil, like bang.
There's a big noise. We know somebody.
Right. Yeah, a lot of noise.
Hopefully,
going on.
They can't hear through the door for the anvil noise.
Strangely enough, it keeps blanging. It's like bang, and it's like, you have nothing to fear from me. This is what you hear. So whatever's on the other side of that door, beaten away on metal, knows you're here.
At the very least, we have a big blacksmith. Is it just kind of like one big clang, or is there a whole series of them?
No, it's just one big clang, very methodical. Clang. And it's been methodical for like ever. In fact, when you're trying to sleep, you were like, it was kind of annoying at first because you kept hearing it bang, and it just methodical and never slowed up, just kept going at this pace.
It's a machine.
And it got so methodical that it actually helped you to sleep at some point because you just got used to it. But yeah, anyway, strangely enough.
All right, well, I guess you open the door then.
Okay, so the door's going to be open.
If he hears us coming and that's what he says, then I don't know.
Sure. So you open the door.
If he was aggressive, wouldn't he just say nothing?
But yeah, there's that.
Do we see any tracks of things walking into this room?
The hell? Yeah, that's a good question.
Like anything up and down this hallway, were there ever tracks? I would know how many now.
Yeah, no. There's lots of tracks back and forth between here. It looks like a very well used area.
What's the freshest ones? Nothing I can distinguish that's any better than anything else?
The freshest ones actually move, I guess at this particular point, move to the north where you guys have already been.
Okay. Yeah. Oh God, that thing looks big.
She looks like an endgame anime boss.
I gotta see this bigger. I've got it small enough. I can't see what it looks like.
No.
Oh, good Lord.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That looks safe.
That's, kind of massive.
Mm-hmm. I like how it's got a triangular head, though. That's actually kind of neat.
All right, so anyway, as you open up this door... I got flavor text. All right, so let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's get some good flavor. And you can see it, so that's interesting. So a forge.
It's hammer time. That's what it looks hammer like. Hammer
time. A forge stands in the middle of this room, surrounded by piles of firewood. Two big anvils stand close by, and hammers, tongs, and other smithing tools are scattered around several workbenches along the chamber's walls. There are doorways to the west and the south, but the eastern end of the room opens up into a dark chasm. So that's what you see. And in fact, I guess between your particular area, I could reveal like this, basically. In fact, you could almost see straight out to the other side. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I'm going to go to, like, here. And then back this way.
I mean, we're about to enter this room, I suspect, so. I mean, maybe this isn't a fight. Maybe this person is a potential ally.
Again, if he was an enemy, why would he say you have nothing to fear from me?
Yeah.
Oh, he said that in response to you failing your stealth check? Was that it?
Yep.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I thought we were hearing a conversation going on inside the room.
No. He knows that you're outside the door. Okay. She knows you were outside the door, so that's fine.
Yeah.
Oh, well, maybe.
So, like, when we open the door, like, and so Eric is standing in the doorway, but I'll peek around the corner and be like, hello.
Hello. All right. And the motion there with the hammer coming down. Here's the thing when you see it, actually. The hammer, as massive as this mallet is, it's like it weighs nothing. Right? And in fact, because what you're looking at right now is floating, moving. Not an apparition, though.
Yeah.
Anybody want to make a, what would you do? Knowledge planes, I guess?
Nope.
Or just not knowledge or...
Sort of
or...
like Jin or something like that? Like one of those guys, maybe?
Basically, yeah.
Hold on.
Like an elemental?
Yeah, there's no knowledge planes, just there's Arcana.
Yeah, okay, knowledge Arcana would do it.
You could be an elemental.
You would have some knowledge.
Oh, my God!
Yeah, okay, so you know what? Specifically,
he's
your character.
An elemental. I would know this.
That's the third one.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
We have lost a quill. All right.
Is it an elemental?
It has an elemental quality, yes.
Qualities. Okay.
Guys. I think it's a water elemental. Pretty sure.
Obviously. Surrounding the stone. Must be water. Alright,
So
wow, Mary Juana!
Priest again?
Thank you for that donation. Massive donation incoming.
What was name of priest again? Cleric.
Okay, we've broken
Sorry, it just says Quill Nat 1 is staying in the chair.
I don't know what this is!
All right. Yeah. No. Give me a Arcana roll or.
Okay. Well, the elementals are like a favorite.
I'm just asking the other PCs if they remember the name of the priest we're supposed to be going after.
I'm just gonna talk to myself for a while. It'll be fine.
I don't remember anything.
Oh, Yarsha.
Yarsha.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fine.
So.
Yeah. What are you trying to say, Ava?
Is it an elemental? Am I gonna know anything about it? Favorite enemy.
Oh, you have a favorite enemy? Elementals?
We worked that out last week, remember?
Okay, sure. Right,
first suggestion, as I recall.
If elemental,
based on what we've been doing, I got a second one, and because that's all we've been just dealing with one elemental thing after the other, you figured that was the next logical choice. The DM gave it to me.
Does the elemental span everything, though? Like every single thing that has an element?
Well, I don't know. I'm just asking you.
Anything
about it?
I'm asking, like...
I don't know if the favorite elemental, if the favorite enemy thing requires a subtype or not for this.
It doesn't the way I read it, but I don't know. Let me check and see if it says anything that makes any difference.
If it has the elemental type, it counts. Okay, fine. All right, so that's what I just Kyoko is telling me. That's how favorite enemy works. Okay,
thank
you.
She's a favorite enemy. It says elementals as one of the options.
Done. All right. So this has an elemental signature. Obviously, it's a stone elemental. You can see that almost just obviously just looking at it. But it is, as far as you know, a djinn. It's actually like a genie, if you will.
A genie.
Yeah.
Okay.
Otherworldly.
And what would that tell me if I knew what that was?
Well, specifically, you know that these types of individuals generally are very pact-based. They make deals. Mm.
Oh,
okay. It also goes really well with tonic.
Yeah, gin and tonics are amazing.
I remember this from about 30 years ago, vaguely something.
So, if you don't mean us any harm, are you not with Yarsha woman?
Yarsha?
Yarsha?
No. My pact was with Marlos, but as far as I can tell, that pact has been broken either by his doing or yours.
Marlos
raised her hand.
What was that, sorry?
I didn't hear.
Marlos fell off a cliff.
Fell.
Yeah. Yeah, no.
I do that in game. Like, I'm like, I peek around the corner again. I say, fell.
Yeah.
Leading around the corner with the air quotes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. All right. It's fine. Because she says, specifically, she says, well, I guess. Yeah, I'm done with this. She reaches down and she grabs on one of the anvils. Actually, on one and then the other one that she's actually already, this seems already finished. There's these two big claws, these claw-looking things. Very reminiscent of something that you would expect to see on the, what's it called there?
The Umber Hulk?
The Umber Hulk, yeah. So there's massive claws all worked, and they're almost, the one is done, seems done anyway, and the other one looks like it's still being worked on. And she just takes them both, whatever, and just throws them behind her, off the cliff.
Those look like useful. Oh.
Oh.
By the way, these two goobers here, what the heck are they? Yeah.
All right, so anyway, as you open the door, and these two guys, they see you, right? They turn to see you, whatever. But then they just sort of, like, back up.
What are they?
They are, Iron Dwarves. Not Iron Dwarves, Grey Dwarves.
Yeah.
Dark Iron Dwarves.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they... Okay. Yeah, we know they're all Dark Iron Dwarves, but yeah, they're the Grey Dwarves, like the ones we've been fighting previously.
Yep. The very same. But they do not attack you.
What's her name?
Right. Oh, say introductions. They're always about introductions. Introductions.
Introduce ourselves, yes.
I am Zarvadim.
Zarvadir.
Deem.
Vardim, okay.
Yeah. D-E-E-M. Deem. Zarvadim. So if you need to remember that name, that's it.
Pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Aye. I am no longer bound to this place. So...
Welcome.
I shall be moving on soon.
But seriously, those claws, though.
Meh. Not my best work. Passable. But only in light of terms... Marlos requested a lot. Almost requested too much. But I am more forgiving than most of my kind.
I'm just saying, though, if we broke that pact, you know, doesn't she owe us something?
Doesn't that mean you're next in line?
Actually, that's a good idea.
I don't really want to mess with her.
If you break the pact, I don't think she automatically gets a pact to you, unless of course there was a deal that if you help break that pact, that she would be. Yeah, no, that doesn't actually go that way.
No, that's fine. That's fine. I'm not going to mess around with this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
If she just wants to poof away back to her elemental plane, I think that's okay.
Yeah.
And she's not attacking us at this point. It's like yay, right?
Yeah, no, one there's no there's no motion to attack.
Although her tools before and stuff she poofs,
nice? Huh?
Do all her tools and stuff look nice?
No. As a blacksmith, as you would know, everything in here is immaculate.
Mm.
Like, it is very, very good quality stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Eric's like,
that's where she goes.
Nice tools.
Yeah, from one blacksmith to another.
I made them myself.
You can compliment her exceptional work and things.
Yep.
Do that, yes. Yeah. But the dwarves, and these dwarves are not attacking.
No, they're not. They're just kind of standing to the side.
I wonder if all the gray dwarves were only involved in this because of her, you know, sort of subservient to the actual stone elemental.
So what's your deal? What do you guys do now that Marlo's gone?
Yeah, let's ask about this deal for sure.
Are you guys moving into the room closer, or are you just kind of like still talking from the doorway?
No, I think
I'm
going
to move in a little bit so I can have like line of sight as I talk to the dwarves.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Given any reasonable wisdom check and stuff like that, you're pretty certain there's no actual danger.
Okay. Before she goes, I would like to inquire if there's anything helpful that she could tell us about the remainder of this I don't know, compound or dungeon or whatever.
Right. Okay.
You know, she can warn us about anything. It would be very helpful. We'd appreciate it.
I did just ask the dwarves what their deal is, or what they're going to do now that Marlos is gone.
Right.
Yeah, okay. You can do the dwarves first.
Okay, so you're asking about the dwarves then. All right, so if you're asking her about the dwarves, it says no.
I just walked around and like asked one of them. Like, so what's your deal? What do you do now that Marlo's gone?
Well, we wait until we can take back our home.
Is this your home?
This is their area. Yeah, this is, I mean.
Trying to take back place from Yarsha and the Earth people?
Actually, one turns and spits, right? And just, like, thinks of Yarsha, right? And just, like, spits on the ground. And Yarsha's always been
Yarsha, more cool. Yarsha.
In fact, Yarsha. No. Yeah. Right, so.
Guys, have we got a deal for you?
Loser.
Right, no. So one turns and spits and just, like, off to the side and specifically says, between Marlos and Yarsha, I would always choose Marlos.
Oh, well, oops.
Yeah.
Well, maybe you don't have to choose either. But you should come with us. We're super good at keeping our allies alive.
We're all we want to do is, right now, we're just looking to get rid of Yarsha. We made a deal. We got to take her out. We didn't like those, like, Earth cult guys anyway. And then we out of here. Then we're leaving.
We're leaving. Yeah,
no. So Zarvadim looks at you, and when she hears this sort of thing, this sort of talk, she says specifically... That because she knows, she feels like the pact's been broken. Says, with Marlos dead, not only is my pact here broken, but there is a vacuum of power in this place. And that vacuum will have to be filled, and Yarsha will probably try to fill it. There are other powers at work, though, and Earth is not one of them anymore. Not the strongest. I feel now flames are heading this way.
Oh, goody. Fire elementals next. Yay!
Where are the flame elements coming from?
Well, there's a pathway to the west that gets warmer and warmer. You'll find it. You just feel the heat as you walk towards the
fire
west.
Comes from hell, guys. That's the steps.
I wonder. Yeah, it could be below us. Yeah, absolutely.
Actually, if you say below it, you say no, not below.
Oh,
below. Oh, just west. You will find more stone than even I can handle.
Oh.
Okay. Oh my God. That's terrifying.
Is that where Yarsha is, or?
No, Yarsha would never dare step foot there unless, of course, she had. And she stops and she looks at you, Eric. And she just stops and she doesn't say anymore. She just kind of grins.
Chair?
The chair. That's what's so weird, right? She looks at you and she just grins. See, she knows that there's an incantation happening there. Yeah, and she knows exactly what's going on. Yeah, no, Iron Fist.
I'm just sitting around the chair, like, I hold one leg, and I've got, like, the rest of it sort of, like, leaning over my shoulder.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, no, so specifically, yeah, no, she does finish eventually. She does say Iron Fang.
Yeah.
Iron Fang, of course, being the name of the pick.
Yeah, so since we have that, going down below is all of a sudden not insta-death, although it still feels like it's probably, like, 95% chance of death.
Yeah, yeah.
Could be a thing. Yeah. Because, actually, you know what, and just in your concern in your face, because down further, you will find Ogrimmok. Ogrimmok is still alive, still well, which you probably can figure out on your own, given the things you have seen.
Okay, so we've learned, what we have learned is that this elemental was here sort of in some sort of, had made a deal, mm-hmm. not all that interested in continuing with the deal, obviously. The two dwarves have not attacked us now, and this was their home. So could we not be asking the dwarves if they want to help us clear their home? We're offering services.
Yeah, I already told them that we're super good at keeping our allies alive.
Give me a diplomacy check.
I know that part, but what we
make it a good one. Because these guys, these guys to you specifically, they don't look like there's no fire in these guys' eye. It looks like it's been beat out of them a long time ago.
Oh.
So give me, you have to make an exceptional
persuasion
diplomacy, or a persuasion.
I mean, do they look like they can fight? Are they're holding a weapon? Or are they just a couple of little guys?
No, they look like the last ones. They just they're not. They look more like just sentries than fighters to you. They look like they haven't actually fought in a very long time.
Okay.
Do you have a decent persuasion?
I could try.
Wow. Eric only intimidates, and it never seems appropriate around here.
Only a 13 passive, plus 3.
Okay. I have higher, but I've been rolling too many ones. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to assist you. I'm just going to, like, nod and, like, be like, yeah, totally, all those things. Yes, totally, uh-huh. Okay, so you get, so you if I assist you, you get advantage.
Okay, so we're going to let them know we would, we seem to be on the same side here. We would like to clear up your home, basically. This is what we're after, too. Mm-hmm. And, are you interested in helping? Can you give us information that helps? Are there others of your kind who would be interested in helping? Who's in here.
You actually get a plus 6, not a plus 3.
Who's on our side?
Okay, well, there's not much to say about that. Any other iron dwarf, they say...
Oh, that was perception. Did
it's
I click
okay, so it's actually 21, not
24.
Oh, I
clicked persuasion.
That's still fine. Yeah, still got over 20, which 20 was the DC I was actually aiming for. Because, again, these guys have been just completely and utterly...
Yeah. I have
20
same
is bonus. Super hard, but yeah.
Yep.
The thing is what's going to happen is they are going to, interestingly enough, give you details. They're not fighting with you, but they know this place better than anybody. And so what one of them does immediately is he moves...
Give us a map.
Yeah, he looks at Zarvadim and just kind of like looks at it, like they make the eye contact, and there's a passive communication there. And what Zarvadim does is she turns and she moves over to the pile over here where there's like wood, but there's also like different types of ore and stuff like that, like metals and such. And she grabs one of the larger chunks and picks it up, moves back to the center, throws it into the fire, and it starts to burn, like, magically faster. It gets hotter than it ever should have at that rate. It just goes whoosh, it gets massive, just starts glowing with this energy.
It's one of those logs from Back to the Future 3, when they're in the Old West and they're trying to make the train go really fast. It's one of those logs.
No. Oh, this one's just going to burn into a holographic, like, smoke map.
No.
Or possibly fire map.
It decides to, this is metal, by the way, not wood. Metal. So, grabs the metal out of the fire, barehanded, puts it on one of the anvils or whatever, and then lifts up her hammer and slams it down just the one time. It just seems like it was effortless. Like, boom, crash, it flattens it out, and you get a full map.
God damn.
You just got a map of this area. You will know.
I'm sorry, I should be more impressed, but I did actually see it coming, but it's still awesome.
Yeah, you will know what is going on in this entire area. Now, you won't even have to question or guess.
Like the Marauder's map. It actually tells us like where everyone is.
I mean, let's say, if we solemnly swear that we're up to no good, can we see where the bad guy is walking?
Yep. So, you just received a map. And here's the thing about this map, is one look at this map, you know that the layout of this area. The thing is...
Next question is, do we want to?
Yeah, when this is also very, it's super magical to the point that you also know the different, traps. You'll know the traps, you'll know the enemies in and around these areas. Like, it's super helpful. Apparently, these dwarves trust you. You talked really well. You said really good words.
Oh, we're just that cute. Yeah.
You have good words, really good words, probably the best words. Sorry.
The best words. Yep. Yeah.
Ah. Okay. It's pretty amazing. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I just hand you this tablet.
Just a little.
Which, strangely enough, as you pick it up, seems to weigh nothing. It should weigh something.
Eric's normally not that effusive.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
So reveal all areas. Yeah, what? I guess I could. The problem in doing that immediately, though, is it's going to be harder for them to remember where they're going. Although, or where they've been. Although what I could do... How would I do that so you guys don't question where you've been? And where you haven't been?
Well, we have bloody marks all over the place. That'll help.
You can move the tokens to like the DM's lair or something like that.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah. If you could move all the monsters and tokens and stuff to the DM lair so that you could reveal the map without revealing where things are, that would be ideal for you.
Okay, let's do that. Let's do it this way. That's actually very helpful. What happened?
I'm just reading chat. I'm sorry. Oh,
what?
I'm sorry.
I don't know what's happening. All right.
It just struck me funny. Sometimes things hit you the right way.
Oh, all right. God. All right. So what's going to happen?
You could just outline the rooms. That's true, too.
I could, but I like this better, being able to just kind of...
Outlining the rooms seems like a pain. If he can group select everything and move it to the DM layer, that's probably...
Yeah.
All right. So here's what's going to happen. Let's just go ahead and reveal all the things. You have a map of this entire area. This is stupendous.
God, we haven't really covered a lot of territory, have we? I'm just looking at what we've actually opened on this level, and it's pretty pathetic.
No, we've done a lot. I don't know what you're talking about. We're almost done this.
Oh, God.
I'm, like, looking at the bounds of the blackness, and we've actually done almost all of it.
I guess. Well, yeah.
Statue room is cool.
There could be another, like, 6 or 8 rooms of relevance, but it's still most of the area we haven't covered.
So yeah, if you know everything about, if there was any traps, you would know all about it. The thing it doesn't cover, and I don't know if I actually mentioned this, if I did, I'm sorry. It doesn't really cover the enemies in the area, because again, enemies move about, so it's kind of it's not the Marauder's map as far as the Marauder's map.
It makes much more sense if you could not show us all the enemies.
Yeah. Well, it does. I know. Let's put
some marks where places you haven't seen yet. Yeah.
Exactly. I'm just putting X's to remind us that we haven't actually seen an area so that, like, we know there might be enemies there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we can be totally confused when we walk back into an area we have explored and they've, like, respawned.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Look at all the stuff.
Oh, we got a torture room. All right.
Oh, that's a rack?
That is a torture rack, yeah. All right.
I don't know. I don't think we should go into Iraq. Nothing
could go wrong. Quagmire.
Like giant quagmire.
Aw. Giggity.
And presumably, this last little section right over here is like to fire, right?
Right.
Unless it's further north. Oh, no. Oh, I haven't looked up north yet.
He said down here, didn't he?
She said west. Specifically
she
to
said
the
west.
West.
She didn't
there
say northwest.
There could theoretically be another way to the west up top, and it looks like there is.
Oh, okay.
Is that everything? I think I'm just making sure.
Looks like there's more to the room with the rack. Or am I just zoomed out too far? Or is it just like fine?
There
is the wall. There's a little bit of black that makes it look like there was more, but yeah.
Yeah, let me just widen it up a bit. There you go.
Not a big deal.
There you go. Right. I think that's everything. I'm still looking, making sure. I don't want to, like, surprise you guys. Especially when you have the map of awesome.
Well, we still have, the hallways that just kind of go blank to the south, to the west. Are those just ending? That's just off the map and we're done?
Sorry, which one? Sorry.
Well, there's a hallway down to the southeast.
That way, yeah. What about it? Sorry.
Well, does it go anywhere? And
yeah.
The hallway
it seems to continue going. As far as the map goes, I mean, there's no rubble or debris there that you can tell from the map, so could be a passage.
She said fire to the west. Can we ask her what's to the south there?
To the south?
Southeast corner?
Right. Yeah, no, she'll tell you specifically. She's like, yes, in mentioning the fire coming from the west, that is indeed where you'll probably find some right now.
Wait.
I can feel
I'm asking
it.
About the one to the south, in the southeast corner.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh, so southeast.
Oh, southeast. Sorry, southeast. No, southwest. Right.
Yes.
Right. So in terms of southwest, she says, if
no, in terms of southeast.
Yeah, if you want to leave this place, that might be a way to go.
Okay, so the southeast is an exit, and the two bits to the west, north and south, go to the fire temple. Mm-hmm.
Exits are good too.
Yep. Exits are really good.
Not having you go, yeah, that's good to know. But yeah, okay. I just like looking at the map. I like ask the dwarves, do you know where on here we might find Yarsha, where she's likely to be? We'd rather just go right there and not have to deal with everyone else.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, unfortunately, she doesn't know where Yarsha could be right now. She does know that Yarsha would not leave this place.
Yeah.
So, Yarsha will be somewhere in here. Just where exactly? Unfortunately, she doesn't know.
Do the dwarves have any idea?
I was trying to ask the dwarves. I thought maybe they would know where she hangs out.
The dwarves? Yeah. No, well, normally... Okay, well, you ask the dwarves where she normally is. Apparently, if you want to zoom out, you can see the ping. Apparently, one of her rooms or one of her beds was back out in this direction here.
Well, that's what I'm not seeing any room that looks like it has a bed in it, that it's personal quarters for anyone.
Yeah, no.
Like nothing really stands out.
She didn't have personal
apartment quarters.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it just sleeps in random beds wherever.
Well, no, she had her own bed, and her own bed was in here.
I'm not seeing where here is.
If you zoom out, you should. Be
in there. Somewhere. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I got it.
Yeah.
This time.
All right.
Yeah, just in one of the dormitories. So.
In one of the. Okay. All right. Yeah.
Zarva goes into flight attendant mode and tells the party the exits are here, here, and here.
What's that scene from the from Aladdin, right? He's like, they get on the fine carpets. Kiss and run to your exits are here, 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 here.
Yeah, all around.
It's a djinn.
Yeah. That'd be some good djinn behavior.
There we go. Do not attempt to move or we'll be shooting ourselves.
So I don't know where we want to go. I mean, we don't have time to do a big fight, although we certainly have time to kick open a door and tease a big fight.
And have a cliffhanger.
You could definitely tease a big fight. So which way do you really want to go?
Well, I kind of like there's that little room that's sort of hidden in the corner where it's all smashed from the room with the pool down south.
Yeah.
And we check that out, and then the room with the rack seems like it's a dead-end room.
Yeah.
So clearing that actually, like...
Okay.
Cuts off an avenue from which stuff could come at us or something. So
yeah.
Let's do that. Yeah, just get some closure on this little area.
Okay.
Close it.
So we'll thank the djinn.
Yeah.
For her help.
Yeah, and in fact, the djinn... does anybody know how to incur a favor from a djinn? Apparently. I mean, maybe you do. Yeah, because you're elemental. You know favorite elements and stuff like that.
Do I?
Specifically, you can enter into a bargain with a djinn. You know this. You can enter into a bargain with a djinn by way of sort of if you help the djinn. Now, this djinn hasn't asked specifically for a favor from you. Perhaps, you know, she doesn't want to because you have other things. You know, maybe she's just being considerate.
Maybe she's got a place to be.
But generally, a djinn does have something they always want.
But and we could ask while we're doing this.
You want to? Yeah, because we don't.
That would be a benefit to you.
We've all been very polite and respectful, but we don't know as well as Lisan about like elementals and crap, so we had no idea to like just ask.
Well, very good. Well, specifically here, this is the fun part, sweetheart. Is the fact that she says yes, there is. There is something you could do.
And he's excited about it. We're in trouble. Go ahead.
Yeah. No. Because down, they took it. They took it down.
They took it down.
My anvil.
Oh.
If you can retrieve that for me, I will owe you a favor.
Ooh.
And when would that favor have to be called in?
Well, anytime.
Anytime.
Yeah, if she gets her anvil back.
We could probably ask her to craft a super item for you, for us.
Yeah. I'm not sure if they're going down, but if we do, we'll keep an eye out for your anvil, for sure.
Depending on, basically, her skill set, whatever her skill set is, it's almost like a wish, but it's, you know, of course, it's bound in within her skill set.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So it's very powerful. Whatever it could be very powerful.
Yeah. But yeah, not sure if we're going down. Wasn't part of our plan, but if we do, we'll keep an eye out for it. I take it your anvil should stand out. Fairly obvious.
And she just nods to you. Like,
yeah.
We'll know it when we see it.
Yeah.
There's no mistaking it. Like, there's okay. No way. Yeah.
The anvil of awesome. Mm-hmm. Okay. We'll keep an eye out for the
just
anvil.
Just like the rest of her tools, like, you would never mistake these tools for being any old blacksmith's tools. You'll know this anvil for what it is.
Very nice.
So and yet, when we find it, is it possible to carry it back up here, or will we be able to summon you to it?
Because
carrying it sounds not great.
Unless it's as lightless as hammer seems to be.
Here's what happens, right? This is exactly what my point was going to be. She takes her hammer and just tosses it to you. It is massive. Whoa. This hammer is massive.
Yeah.
Tosses it to you.
Yep.
I'm not going to have you roll a dex check or anything like that, because, yeah. It's too big to miss, really. If you just stood there, you'd catch it. But yeah, so you catch it, and it weighs practically nothing.
Oh.
What do you do? Smack the anvil with the hammer when we find it?
No. She calls it back to herself.
I think what she wanted, the idea is to throw it back to herself.
Can you carry it? Like, if you can carry it, yes. Yeah,
the anvil will be fine.
Is the idea that you should be able to carry the anvil, no problem.
Okay. Oh, cool.
We bring it back here, or are you leaving, or what? We're not sure we're going down there.
Yeah, no, maybe. She says specifically that she is indeed leaving. Don't worry about finding her, she will find you.
Okay, all right.
Okay. If we have her anvil, she'll find us.
Yep.
Yeah.
I like this.
And if she doesn't find us, hey, free anvil.
Actually, there's a hint of appreciation in that comment. Like, do not worry about finding me, I will find you. But there's also that sort of hint of a sinister thing, where if you try to take the anvil, you kind of get a hint of
retribution. Once we have the anvil,
retribution.
She will find us.
Yes.
Yeah, I caught that. Yes. Yeah. Exactly. That seems,
so you know, it's kind of like it's a hidden sort of thing, but not so hidden.
It seems...
It's a threat,
basically,
to some degree.
Just a promise.
Yep.
Just a promise. Okay, so let's go. Yep. We've only got a few minutes before
thank
we
her for all of her help, and then I think we'll head down and try and do, like, check out these couple of places here.
Yeah, no, here, before you leave, specifically, what she does is she nods to both the dwarves there, and she takes her hammer, lifts it up, slams the ground with it, and just like that, you see dust. Just actual, like, little pebbles and stuff like that. Just dust just scatters in and around, and just that's it. She's gone.
She's gone. Alrighty. Alright.
She leaves.
There you be.
She's no longer there.
She incorporates into dust. Okay. She dust corporates.
Done. Okay. Yeah. Alright, so you guys are going to move down that way. So where are we going?
We're checking that little corner. Is there something hiding behind there?
What is your passive perception? Okay, your passive perception is still 16, so that's good. As you're passing by this door, you don't have to roll stealth checks or anything.
Okay.
Because God knows you'll probably fail it.
Yay!
Sorry. Playing an accordion. Anyway, so this particular door right here, you hear a commotion. In fact, you can't help but not hear the commotion that's happening in behind that door.
Mm-hmm. Oh, goody. What kind of commotion? Angry voices? Does it sound like a fight?
Is somebody
having a party?
It sounds like
a
tussle.
Are they dancing?
Almost, honestly, it sounds almost like a war.
A roar?
A war? Yeah.
Holy, a war is going on.
It is crazy beyond that door.
Gentlemen, you can't fight here. This is the war room.
Or it could just be a roar, and he's suddenly taking on a bizarre, like, lispy sort of accent.
A war.
It's a gwar concert.
It's not even entertaining. It's a boar.
It's just some Mel Brooks stuff. It's like, there's a lion in there. There's a lion. It wars. It wars really loud.
Whatever your interpretation, sure.
Yeah. All right. Hey, sorry, was that in the torch room?
Hmm?
Is that in the torch room?
I think the one to the left.
Over here, yeah.
Okay, well, I will let the guys know very quietly. Can you hear that? I mean, yeah. There's a battle of some sort going on. This is insane.
Well,
I think no door comes first. Let's just check where there's no door quickly.
Yeah, let's just check over here.
Okay.
Nothing coming behind us.
Yep. So if you go and check over there, there's absolutely nothing there. It's just a bunch. It's remarkably boring.
Lisanne has the best hearing. Maybe she should just see if she can listen over here to see if there's anyone in that room.
Yeah.
Can I hear it? Do I have to roll? I have a passive 16.
Yeah, give me a stealth roll.
A stealth roll?
Yeah, if you're going to this door. This door here?
Yeah.
No, we're going to the door to listen.
Yeah, okay, so stealth roll.
Okay.
Yeah.
Foiled.
Mm-hmm. Couldn't possibly roll worse than I've been rolling today.
Yeah, it couldn't possibly happen.
Ooh. Roll pretty much the same. Worse.
Yeah. So you are
doing so good.
14.
Yeah. This is fantastic. All right. So,
could you?
So, you
I'm taking luck next time we have an option.
Yeah, I know, right?
You hear specifically behind the door. It's like, "Shh, I think Yarsh is coming."
What did it say?
"I think Yarsh is coming." It just told it's just, "Shh, I think Yarsh is coming."
Behind
this
door.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Well,
they
might be opposed to Yarsha.
Clearly.
They might be actual allies.
What was the tone of voice? Like, "Hush, she's coming."
Yeah.
Or,
it was kind of like
worried.
A quick rush of footsteps as well, you hear.
Shoot the bet.
Let's do it. Let's open the door.
Yeah, Eric just comes to the door and try and stay through there. It's like, "No, we're just looking for Yarsha, you know, the killer and stuff."
perfect.
Might as well.
So what you hear in return specifically is "I'm not familiar with your voice. We would never betray Yarsha.
What's that?
He says, "I'm not familiar with your voice, but we would never betray Yarsha."
"No, because we already took out Marlos. We get rid of Yarsha, and then, you know, you're all clear."
Mm-hmm.
"Whatever, I'll just, kick open the door now and see if it's a fight."
Just do it.
Yeah, because if they may still be friendly to Yarsha and they were just worried about getting caught
or
something like that, then they're going to fight us anyway, and they know we're here, so we'll find out. But, yeah.
Okay,
so
the door is now kicked open.
Yeah, sorry, I'm up there.
Accordion of thunder.
All right, so that's what you get.
Oh, they're not Dwargar. Okay.
Boo.
Mm-hmm.
All kinds of things. Oh, cracky doo. Nobody's on the rack. They're not actually torturing anybody. They're just hanging out.
A quick look to the cages inside. There are definitely people in several forms of harm in these cages.
Ooh, okay.
Various forms of harm. And, all right. Of course, there's not just, you know, there's shackles and things like that, but there is also blood in and about the area, too.
Yeah, I vote for we don't try to parlay with these guys. They deserve to die.
I don't think so either. Kill them.
If they're more of the monks, and they just said they won't betray Yarsha, I think we're probably... Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Just kill them. You walk in the room, you take a look around, and you go, "Just wrong."
All right.
Just wrong.
So you get a sense of very much wrong.
This is just wrong.
So we have flavor text. I'm gonna read that to you. "A wooden torture rack stands in the middle of this room. Manacles hang from the walls and fiendish hooks and blades and clamps hang on the back wall. Four cramped iron cages stand in the room's western alcove, occupied by gaunt, dirty humans with blank gazes. In the room's eastern alcove stand two double bunks and an iron stove."
Okay.
"Somebody sleeps in here? Yeah, kill them." "These are not good people."
God. So, that's what you get.
Oh, God.
So, yeah, you're just going to vote for charge in and kill again?
Well,
it's just like heroes, right? You see people, you kill them. It's fine.
Yeah, well, just Do we want to be making deals with people who do this sort of thing?
Maybe.
No, I don't think it matters. They're loyal. They're worried about her just like being, you know, underlings worried about stuff.
Yeah, the boss is coming by. Look busy.
Yeah, they seem to be loyal. I have no reason to disbelieve that they're loyal, so I think we should take them out.
Well, I mean, you can ask again. Okay, guys, we killed your one boss. Do you really want to deal with this? Like, where do your loyalties... I mean, you can ask again if you want, but I'm just thinking, I don't know.
Yeah, no, they're the torture guys, whatever. It's fine.
They're torture guys, exactly. Yep, they're torture.
Too late, torture.
You know, it's fine. Well, those were my... I'm only following orders. It's just bullshit.
All right, so you guys are brandishing and looking kind of fierce, ready to fight?
Oh, fierce.
So, okay, we're looking like we're rolling initiative, is what we're looking like.
All right, so if we're going to roll initiative, we will wait till next time.
Okay, yep. 20 minutes.
But what I will say is, as you brandish your weapons or whatever, he stands with a staff, he clicks it twice on the ground, and he's like, I was looking for fresh meat.
There you go, we made them. See, you gotta just trust your gut instincts. Mm-hmm. Killing.
Yeah, no, he looks specifically at Lasan as well. Like, he hasn't tortured an elf in a long while, so. All right, there's that. So... All right, everybody, this is going to bring a close to the Sunday Morning Heroes for today. And I will say, specifically in about 20 minutes from now-ish, kind of, there will be the live stream coming in from A Kiss for Luck. What game are you playing?
Quill and I. Where Quill is continuing his tutorial of Factorio.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
The Factorial?
Factorio. Yeah. That's amazing.
It's a big exclamation mark.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah,
so, yes. In just a few minutes, that's going to happen. That's very exciting. So look forward to that. I will be hosting them from here. But do be sure and pop on over to A Kiss for Lux live stream and give her a follow. Because, I mean, fantastic personality as well. Easy to listen to. Sit back. Enjoy yourself. And, yeah, I have to take off. And till next time, Quill, where can people find you?
Well, people can find me at youtube.com/Quill18 and twitch.tv/Quill18. And you can always tweet me. At Quill18 as well.
Absolutely. And Demonite, where can people find you?
Well, you can find the illustrated tales from my D&D campaign at youtube.com/Demonac. And you can find all my social media and stuff like that at www.demonac.com.
Excellent. And A Kiss for Luck. Besides your Twitch, where can people find you?
Twitch, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, akissforluck.net. It's all A Kiss for Luck using the number 4.
So
I think
lucky.
Kiss for Luck everywhere.
So lucky. All right.
All the places.
So anywhere A Kiss for Luck, you will find it. And speaking of myself, obviously you can find me here on twitch.tv/Briarstone, but I also have, if you scroll down, if you're watching this on Twitch, not YouTube, obviously, you can scroll down right now and you can see links to my social media as well as to YouTube and other such things. If you are so inclined, check that out. And we're taking off. We'll see you again later.
Thanks, guys. This was good.
Yeah.
It was a good one.
There's going to be more stuff happening very, very soon.
It's always fun.
You guys have a torture guy.
It's a scorpion, yeah.
And perhaps a war zone to your west there. So that's interesting. Next time.
Next time.
Previously. No, sorry. Okay, I'm taking off. Later, everybody.
Bye-bye, folks. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.